The Law of One, unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark, and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 1. I am RAW. I have not spoken through this instrument before. We had to wait until she was precisely tuned. As we send a narrow band vibration, we greet you in the love and in the light of our infinite creator. We have watched your group. We have been called to your group, for you have a need for the diversity of experiences and channeling which go with a more intensive, or as you might call it, advanced approach to the system of studying the patterns of the illusions of your body, your mind, and your spirit, which you call seeking the truth. We hope to offer you a somewhat different slant upon the information which is always and ever the same. The Confederation of Planets in the service of the Infinite Creator has only one important statement. That statement, my friends, as you know, is all things, all of life, all of the creation is part of one original thought. We will exercise each channel if we are able to. The reception of our beam is a somewhat more advanced feat than some of the more broad vibration channels opened by other members for more introductory and intermediate work. Let us for a moment consider thought. What is it, my friends, to take thought? Took you then thought today? What thoughts did you think today? What thoughts were part of the original thought today? In how many of your thoughts did the creation abide? Was love contained? And was service freely given? You are not part of a material universe. You are part of a thought. You are dancing in a ballroom in which there is no material. You are dancing thoughts. You move your body, your mind, and your spirit in somewhat eccentric patterns, for you have not completely grasped the concept that you were part of the original thought. We would at this time transfer to an instrument known as Don. I am RAW. 2 minute pause. I am RAW. I am again with this instrument. We are close to initiating a contact but are having difficulty penetrating a certain mental tension and distraction that is somewhat characteristic of this channel. We will therefore describe the type of vibration which is being sent. The instrument will find us entering the energy field at a slight angle towards the back of the top of the head in a narrow but strong area of intensity. We are not able to offer any conditioning due to our own transmitting limitations. Therefore, if the instrument can feel this particular effect, he may then speak our thoughts as they come to him. We will again attempt this contact. I am RAW. 90 second pause. This instrument is resisting our contact. However, we assure her that we are satisfied that contact with the one known as Don is not at this time preferable to that instrument. We will, therefore, move on to the one known as Leonard. Again, we caution the instrument that it is a narrow band communication which is felt as a vibration entering the aura. We will now transfer this contact. I am RAW. 90 second pause. I am RAW. We greet you once more in the love and the light of our infinite creator. We ask that you be patient with us, for we are a difficult channel to receive. However, we may perhaps add some dimensions to your understanding. At this time, we would be glad to attempt to speak to any subject or question which those entities in the room may have potential use in the requesting. Questioner, it seems members of the Confederation have a specific purpose. Is this true with you? And if so, what is your purpose? I am RAW. We communicate now. We too have our place. We are not those of the love or of the light. We are those who are of the Law of One. In our vibration, the polarities are harmonized, the complexities are simplified, and the paradoxes have their solution. We are one. That is our nature and our purpose. We are old upon your planet and have served with varying degrees of success in transmitting the Law of One, of unity, of singleness to your peoples. We have walked your earth. We have seen the faces of your peoples. This is not so with many of the entities of the Confederation. We found it was not efficacious. However, we then felt the great responsibility of staying in the capacity of removing the distortions and powers that had been given to the Law of One. We will continue in this until your, shall we say, cycle is appropriately ended. If not this one, then the next. We are not a part of time and, thus, are able to be with you in any of your times. Does this give you enough information from which to extract our purpose, my brother? Questioner, yes, it does. Thank you. We appreciate your vibration. Is there another query? Questioner, I've heard of the name RAW in connection with the Egyptians. Are you connected with that RAW in any way? I am RAW. Yes, the connection is congruency. May we elucidate? Questioner, please do. What do you not understand? Questioner, could you give me a little more detail about your role with the Egyptians? I am RAW. The identity of the vibration RAW is our identity. We as a group, or what you would call a social memory complex, made contact with a race of your planetary kind which you call Egyptians. Others from our density made contact at the same time in South America, and the so-called lost cities with their attempts to contribute to the Law of One. We spoke to one who heard and understood and was in a position to decree the Law of One. However, the priests and peoples of that era quickly distorted our message, robbing it of the, shall we say, compassion with which unity is informed by its very nature. Since it contains all, it cannot abhor any. When we were no longer able to have appropriate channels through which to enunciate the Law of One, we removed ourselves from the now hypocritical position which we had allowed ourselves to be placed in. And other myths, shall we say, other understandings having more to do with polarity and the things of your vibrational complex, again took over in that particular society complex. Does this form a sufficient amount of information? Or could we speak further? Questioner, inaudible. Is there another query? Questioner, the question was lost because the questioner was sitting too far from the tape recorder to be recorded. I am raw. Consider, if you will, that the universe is infinite. This has yet to be proven or disproven, but we can assure you that there is no end to yourselves, your understanding, what you would call your journey of seeking, or your perceptions of the creation. That which is infinite cannot be many. For manyness is a finite concept. To have infinity you must identify or define that infinity as unity. Otherwise, the term does not have any referent or meaning. In an infinite creator there is only unity. You have seen simple examples of unity. You have seen the prism which shows all colors stemming from the sunlight. This is a simplistic example of unity. In truth there is no right or wrong. There is no polarity, for all will be, as you would say, reconciled at some point in your dance through the mind-body-spirit complex which you amuse yourself by distorting in various ways at this time. This distortion is not in any case necessary. It is chosen by each of you as an alternative to understanding the complete unity of thought which binds all things. You are not speaking of similar or somewhat like entities or things. You are everything, every being, every emotion, every event, every situation. You are unity. You are infinity. You are love light. Like love, you are. This is the Law of One. May we enunciate this law in more detail? Questioner, inaudible. Is there another query at this time? Questioner, can you say anything about the coming planetary changes? Background noise. I am raw. I preferred to wait until this instrument had again reached the proper state of depth of singleness or one-pointedness before we spoke. The changes are very, very trivial. We do not concern ourselves with the conditions which bring about harvest. Questioner, another question. Is it possible to create any acceleration of understanding in other entities, or are all efforts by the individual on himself accelerating his understanding? In other words, if an individual tries to act as a catalyst in general to increase the awareness of planetary consciousness, is he doing nothing but acting upon himself, or is it possible? Inaudible. I am raw. We shall answer your question in two parts, both of which are important equally. Firstly, you must understand that the distinction between yourself and others is not visible to us. We do not consider that a separation exists between the consciousness-raising efforts of the distortion which you project as a personality and the distortion which you project as another personality. Thus, to learn is the same as to teach, unless you are not teaching what you are learning, in which case you have done you they little or no good. This understanding should be pondered by your mind-body-spirit complex, as it is a distortion which plays a part in your experiences at this nexus. To turn to the second part of our response, may we state our understanding, limited though it is. Side 2 of the tape of session 1 was taped over by the Sunday night meditation which followed it. The following is as published in book I. Group individuated consciousness is that state of sharing understanding with the other distortions of mind-body-spirit complexes, which are within the evident reach of the mind-body-spirit complex individual or group. Thus, we are speaking to you and accepting both our distortions and your own in order to enunciate the laws of creation, more especially the Law of One. We are not available to many of your peoples, for this is not an easily understood way of communication or type of philosophy. However, our very being is hopefully a poignant example of both the necessity and the near hopelessness of attempting to teach. Each of those in this group is striving to use, digest, and diversify the information which we are sending this instrument into the channels of the mind-body-spirit complex without distortion. The few whom you will illuminate by sharing your light are far more than enough reason for the greatest possible effort. To serve one is to serve all. Therefore, we offer the question back to you to state that indeed it is the only activity worth doing, to learn teach or teach learn. There is nothing else which is of aid in demonstrating the original thought except your very being, and the distortions that come from the unexplained, inarticulate, or mystery-clad being are many. Thus, to attempt to discern and weave your way through as many group mind-body-spirit distortions as possible among your peoples in the course of your teaching is a very good effort to make. We can speak no more valiantly of your desire to serve. May we speak in any other capacity upon this subject? Questioner, will you be available for communication? Can we call on you in the future? I am Raw. We have good contact with this instrument because of her recent experiences with trance. She is to be able to communicate our thoughts in your future. However, we advise care in disturbing the channel for a few moments and then the proper procedure for aiding an instrument who has, to some extent, the need of re-entering the mind-body-spirit complex which the instrument has chosen for the life experience of this time-space. Do you understand how to nurture this instrument? Questioner, no. Could you explain it? We suggest first a brief period of silence. Then the repetition of the instrument's vibratory complex of sound in your density which you call name. Repeat until an answer is obtained. Then the laying on of the hands at the neck region for a brief period so that the instrument may recharge batteries which are not, shall we say, full of the essence of this particular field at this time. And finally, a gift of water into which the love of all present has been given. This will restore this entity, for her distortions contain great sensitivity towards the vibrations of love and the charged water will affect comfort. Do you now understand? Questioner, not completely. I am Raw. Research your mind to find the vibration Alrak. It is this vibration from you which contains the largest amount of what you would call love. Others would call this entity Kala. The charging of the water is done by those present placing their hands over the glass and visualizing the power of love entering the water. This will charge that very effective medium with those vibrations. This instrument is, at this time, quite fatigued. However, her heart is such that she continues to remain open to us and useful as a channel. This is why we have spent the time-space explaining how the distortions of what you may call fatigue may be ameliorated. Under no circumstances should this instrument be touched until she has responded to her name. I do not wish to take this instrument beyond her capacity for physical energy. It grows low. Therefore, I must leave this instrument. I leave you in the glory and peace of unity. Go forth in peace, rejoicing in the power of the One Creator. I am Raw. End of Session 1. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as Raw. Session 2. I am Raw. I greet you in the love and the light of our infinite Creator. I am with this mind-body-spirit complex which has offered itself for a channel. I communicate with you. Queries are in order in your projections of mind distortion at this time-space. Thusly would I assure this group that my own social memory complex has one particular method of communicating with those few who may be able to harmonize their distortions with ours, and that is to respond to queries for information. We are comfortable with this format. May the queries now begin. Questioner, I'm guessing that there are enough people who would understand what you are saying, interested enough for us to make a book of communications with it, and I wondered if you would agree to this, us making a book, and if so, I was thinking that possibly a bit of historical background on yourself would be in order. Inaudible question. I am Raw. The possibility of communication, as you would call it, from the one to the one through distortion acceptable for meaning is the reason we contacted this group. There are few who will grasp, without significant distortion, that which we communicate through this connection with this mind-body-spirit complex. However, if it be your desire to share our communications with others, we have the distortion towards a perception that this would be most helpful in regularizing and crystallizing your own patterns of vibration upon the levels of experience which you call the life. If one is illuminated, are not all illuminated? Therefore, we are oriented towards speaking for you in whatever supply of speakingness you may desire. To teach, learn is the law of one in one of its most elementary distortions. Questioner, could you tell us something of your historical background, your earlier times in the illusion and the time state? Contact, possibly your incarnation on this planet that you spoke of before, and contact with earlier races on this planet, then we would have something to start with in writing this book. I am Raw. We are aware that your mind-body is calculating the proper method of performing the task of creating a teach-learning instrument. We are aware that you find our incarnate, as you call it, state of interest. We waited for a second query so as to emphasize that the time-space of several thousand of your years creates a spurious type of interest. Thus, in giving this information, we ask the proper lack of stress be placed upon our experiences in your local space-time. The teach learning which is our responsibility is philosophical rather than historical. We shall now proceed with your request which is harmless if properly evaluated. We are those of the Confederation who 11,000 of your years ago came to two of your planetary cultures which were at the time closely in touch with the creation of the One Creator. It was our naive belief that we could teach learn by direct contact and the free will distortions of individual feeling or personality were in no danger, we thought, of being disturbed as these cultures were already closely aligned with an all-embracing belief in aliveness or consciousness of all. We came and were welcomed by the peoples whom we wished to serve. We attempted to aid them in technical ways having to do with the healing of mind-body-spirit complex distortions through the use of the crystal, appropriate to the distortion, placed within a certain appropriate series of ratios of time-space material. Thus were the pyramids created. We found that the technology was reserved largely for those with the effectual mind-body distortion of power. This was not intended by the law of one. We left your peoples. The group that was to work with those in the area of South America, as you call that portion of your sphere, gave up not so easily. They returned. We did not. However, we have never left your vibration due to our responsibility for the changes in consciousness we had first caused and then found distorted in ways not relegated to the law of one. We attempted to contact the rulers of the land to which we had come, that land which you call Egypt, or in some areas, the Holy Land. In the 18th dynasty, as it is known in your records of space-time distortions, we were able to contact a pharaoh, as you would call him. The man was small in life experience on your plane and was a what this instrument would call wanderer. Thus, this mind-body-spirit complex received our communication distortions and was able to blend his distortions with our own. This young entity had been given a vibratory complex of sound which vibrated in honor of a prosperous god, as this mind-body complex, which we call instrument for convenience, would call Amon. The entity decided that this name, being in honor of one among many gods, was not acceptable for inclusion in his vibratory sound complex. Thus, he changed his name to one which honored the sun disk. This distortion, called Aten, was a close distortion to our reality as we understand our own nature of mind-body-spirit complex distortion. However, it does not come totally into alignment with the intended teach learning which was sent. This entity, Akhenaten, became convinced that the vibration of one was the true spiritual vibration and thus decreed the law of one. However, this entity's beliefs were accepted by very few. His priests gave lip service only, without the spiritual distortion towards seeking. The peoples continued in their beliefs. When this entity was no longer in this density, again the polarized beliefs in the many gods came into their own and continued so until the one known as Muhammad delivered the peoples into a more intelligible distortion of mind-body-spirit relationships. Do you have a more detailed interest at this time? Questioner, we are very interested in the entire story that you have to tell and in getting into the law of one in quite some detail. There will be several questions that I'll ask as we go along that may or may not be related directly to understanding the law of one. However, I believe that the proper way of presenting this as a teach-learning vehicle to the population of the planet that will read it at this time is to investigate different facets of what you tell us. You spoke of crystal healing. One other thing I might mention is that when the instrument becomes fatigued, we want to cut off communication and resume it at a later time after the instrument is recharged. And if the instrument is suitable at this time, I would like a little discussion of the crystal healing that you mentioned. I am Ra. The principle of crystal healing is based upon an understanding of the hierarchical nature of the structure of the illusion, which is the physical body, as you would call it. There are crystals which work upon the energies coming into the spiritual body. There are crystals which work upon the distortions from spirit to mind. There are crystals which balance the distortions between the mind and the body. All of these crystal healings are charged through purified channels. Without the relative crystallization of the healer working with the crystal will not be properly charged. The other ingredient is a proper alignment with the energy fields of the planet upon which you dwell and the holistic or cosmic distortions or streamings which enter the planetary aura in such a manner that an appropriate ratio of shapes and placement within these shapes is of indicated aid in the untangling or balancing process. To go through the various crystals to be used would be exhaustive to this instrument, although you may ask us if you wish in another session. The delicacy, shall we say, of the choosing of the crystal is very critical and, in truth, A crystalline structure such as a diamond or ruby can be used by a purified channel who is filled with the love light of one in almost any application. This, of course, takes initiation, and there have never been many to persevere to the extent of progressing through the various distortion leavings which initiation causes. May we further inform you in any fairly brief way upon this or another subject? Questioner, yes. You mentioned that the pyramids were an outgrowth of this. Could you expand a little bit on were you responsible for the building of the pyramid, and what was the purpose of the pyramid? I am Ra. The larger pyramids were built by our ability using the forces of one. The stones are alive. It has not been so understood by the mind-body-spirit distortions of your culture. The purposes of the pyramids were two. Firstly, to have a properly oriented place of initiation for those who wish to become purified or initiated channels for the Law of One. 2. We wish then to carefully guide the initiates in developing a healing of the people whom they sought to aid and the planet itself. Pyramid after pyramid charged by the crystal and initiate were designed to balance the incoming energy of the one creation with the many and multiple distortions of the planetary mind-body-spirit. In this effort we were able to continue work that brothers within the Confederation had effected through building of other crystal-bearing structures and thus complete a ring, if you will, of these about the Earths. As this instrument would have us vibrate it, surface. This instrument begins to lose energy. We ask for one more query or subject and then we shall take our leave for this time space. Questioner, you might mention there was originally a capstone on the pyramid at the top. What was it made of and how you moved the heavy blocks to build the pyramid? What technique was used for that? I am Ra. I request that we be asked this question in our next work time, as you would term the distortion sharing that our energies produce. If you have any questions about the proper use of this mind-body-spirit, we would appreciate your asking them now. Questioner, consider them asked. I mean, I don't have anything to go on. What is the proper use of this instrument? What should we do to maximize our ability to comfort, rejuvenation, etc.? I am Ra. We are pleased that you asked this question, for it is not our understanding that we have the right duty to share our perceptions on any subject but philosophy without direct question. However, this mind-body-spirit is not being correctly used and therefore is experiencing unnecessary distortions of body in the area of fatigue. The vibrations may well be purified by a simple turning to the circle of one and the verbal vibration while doing so of the following dialogue. Question. What is the Law? Answer. The Law is One. Question. Why are we here? Answer. We seek the Law of One. Question. Why do we seek Ra? Answer. Ra is an humble messenger of the Law of One. Both together, rejoice then and purify this place in the Law of One. Let no thought form enter the circle we have walked about this instrument, for the Law is One. The instrument at this time should be in trance. The proper alignment is the head pointed 20 degrees north by northeast. This is the direction from which the newer or new age distortions of love light, which are less distorted, are emanating from, and this instrument will find comfort therein. This is a sensitive instrument, by which we mean the distortions which enter her mind-body-spirit complex come from any of her senses. Thus, it is well to do the following. Place at the entity's head a virgin chalice of water. To the center, the book most closely aligned with the instrument's mental distortions which are allied most closely with the Law of One, that being the Bible that she touches most frequently. To the other side of the Bible, a small amount of sense, or incense, in a virgin censer. To the rear of the book symbolizing one, opened to the Gospel of John, chapter 1. A white candle. The instrument would be strengthened by the wearing of a white robe. The instrument shall be covered and prone, the eyes covered. We feel that, though this is a complex of activity circumstance and may seem very distorted from a purposeful teach-learning experience, these elaborations on the technique of trance will ease the mind distortions of those about the instrument as they perceive improvement in the instrument's distortions with regard to fatigue. We add only that if these teach-learning sessions are held during time-space during which your sun body does not light your room, that it is best to call the instrument before the lighting of the illuminatory mechanism. I am Ra. I leave you in the glory and the peace of the One Creator. Rejoice in the love light, and go forth in the power of the One Creator. Enjoy. We leave you, Adonai. End of Session 2. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as Ra. Session 3. I am Ra. I greet you in the love and the light of the One Infinite Creator. I communicate with you now. Questioner, my first question is, Did we correctly perform the ritual for starting the communication? I am Raw. The placement of the artifacts designed to balance the instrument should be placed at the instrument's head for the least distortion of effect. The remainder of the beginning account of purpose is quite acceptable, but those speaking desire to serve. Otherwise, the attendant emphasis in mind complexities would not have been affected properly. We caution you to guard against those who are not wishing to serve others above all else from taking part in the beginning or in lending their distortions of mind-body-spirit complex to any session, as we should then be unable to properly blend our distortions with those of this instrument. Questioner, should I move the Bible, candle, and incense at this time? I am Raw. This would be appropriate. Questioner, after moving the items, is this the proper position? I am Raw. Please correct the angle of the incense so that it is perpendicular to the plane of 20 degrees north by northeast. Questioner, after making the correction, is this satisfactory? Please check your eye to make fine correction. We will explain the process by which this becomes a significant distortion balancer. The incense acts as energizer to the physical body of this instrument, signifying its humanity. This is, therefore, a necessity that the wafted smoke is perceived from the same relative angle as the instrument perceives the opened Bible balanced by the lighted candle, signify love, light and light love, and, therefore, give the mental and emotional, shall we call it, distortion complex of this instrument the sight of paradise and peace which it seeks. Thus energized from the lower to the higher, the instrument becomes balanced and does not grow fatigued. We appreciate your concern, for this will enable our teach learning to proceed more easily. Questioner, does it appear correctly aligned now? I judge it within limits of acceptability. Questioner, at the last session we had two questions we were saving for this session, one having to do with the possible capstone of the Great Pyramid at Giza, the other, inaudible heavy blocks. I know these questions are of no importance at all with respect to the law of one, but it was my judgment, which you may correct, that this would provide an easy entry for the reader of the material. We are very grateful for your contact and will certainly take suggestions about how we should proceed with this. This is just one guess. I am Raw. I will not suggest the proper series of questions. This is your prerogative as free agent of the law of one, having learned understood that our social memory complex cannot effectually discern the distortions of the societal mind-body-spirit complex of your peoples. We wish now to fulfill our teach learning honor responsibility by answering what is asked. This only will suffice, for we cannot plumb the depths of the distortion complexes which infect your peoples. The first question, therefore, is the capstone. We iterate the unimportance of this type of data. The so-called Great Pyramid had two capstones. One was of our design and was of smaller and carefully contrived pieces of the material upon your planet which you call granite. This was contrived for crystalline properties and for the proper flow of your atmosphere via a type of what you would call chimney. At a time when we as a people had left your density, the original was taken away and a more precious one substituted. It consisted, in part, of a golden material. This did not change the properties of the pyramid, as you call it, at all, and was a distortion due to the desire of a few to mandate the use of the structure as a royal place only. Do you wish to query further upon this first question? Questioner, what did you mean by chimney? What was its specific purpose? There is a proper flow of your atmosphere which, though small, freshens the whole of the structure. This was designed by having airflow ducts, as this instrument might call them, situated so that there was a freshness of atmosphere without any disturbance or draft. Questioner, how were the blocks moved? I am Raw. You must picture the activity within all that is created. The energy is, though finite, quite large compared to the understanding distortion of your peoples. This is an obvious point well known to your peoples, but little considered. This energy is intelligent. It is hierarchical. Much as your mind-body-spirit complex dwells within an hierarchy of vehicles and retains, therefore, the shell, or shape, or field, and the intelligence of each ascendingly intelligent or balanced body, so does each atom of such a material as rock. When one can speak to that intelligence, the finite energy of the physical, or chemical, rock body is put into contact with that infinite power which is resident in the more well-tuned bodies, be they human or rock. With this connection made, a request may be given. The intelligence of infinite rockness communicates to its physical vehicle, and that splitting and moving which is desired is then carried out through the displacement of the energy field of rockness from finity to a dimension which we may conveniently call, simply, infinity. In this way, that which is required is accomplished due to the cooperation of the infinite understanding of the Creator indwelling in the living rock. This is, of course, the mechanism by which many things are accomplished which are not subject to your present means of physical analysis of action at a distance. Questioner, I am reminded of the statement, approximately, if you had enough faith, you could say to a mountain to move and the mountain would move. I assume this is approximately what you are saying, and I am assuming that if you are fully aware of the law of one, then you are able to do these things. Is that correct? I am raw. The vibratory distortion of sound, faith, is perhaps one of the stumbling blocks between those of what we may call the infinite path and those of the finite proving understanding. You are precisely correct in your understanding of the congruency of faith and intelligent infinity. However, one is a spiritual term, the other more acceptable perhaps to the conceptual framework distortions of those who seek with measure and pen. Questioner, then if an individual is totally informed with respect to the law of one and lives, and is the law of one, such things as the building of a pyramid by direct mental effort would be commonplace. Is that what I am to understand? Am I correct? I am raw. You are incorrect in that there is a distinction between the individual power through the law of one and the combined, or societal memory complex mind-body-spirit understanding of the law of one. In the first case, only the one individual, purified of all flaws, could move a mountain. In the case of mass understanding of unity, each individual may contain an acceptable amount of distortion and yet the mass mind could move mountains. The progress is normally from the understanding which you now seek to a dimension of understanding which is governed by the laws of love, and which seeks the laws of light. Those who are vibrating with the law of light seek the law of one. Those who vibrate with the law of one seek the law of foreverness. We cannot say what is beyond this dissolution of the unified self with all that there is, for we still seek to become all that there is, and still are we raw. Thus our paths go onward. Questioner, was the pyramid then built by the mutual action of many of your people? I am raw. The pyramids which we thought built were constructed from thought forms created by our social memory complex. Questioner, then the rock was created by thought in place rather than moved from somewhere else? Is that correct? I am raw. We built with everlasting rock the great pyramid, as you call it. Other of the pyramids were built with stone moved from one place to another. Questioner, what is everlasting rock? I am raw. If you can understand the concept of thought forms, you will realize that the thought form is more regular in its distortion than the energy fields created by the materials in the rock, which has been created through thought form from thought to finite energy and beingness in your, shall we say, distorted reflection of the level of the thought form. May we answer you in any more helpful way? Questioner, this is slightly trivial, but I was wondering why, in that case, the pyramid was made of many blocks rather than the whole thing being created at once. I am raw. There is a law which we believe to be one of the more significant primal distortions of the law of one. That is the law of confusion. You have called this the law of free will. We wish to make an healing machine, or time-space ratio complex which was as efficacious as possible. However, we did not desire to allow the mystery to be penetrated by the peoples in such a way that we became worshipped as builders of a miraculous pyramid. Thus it appears to be made, not thought. Questioner, well, then you speak of the pyramid, especially the Great Pyramid, I assume, as primarily a healing machine and also spoke of it as a device for initiation. Are these one and the same concepts? They are part of one complex of love, light, intent, sharing. To use the healing aspects properly, it was important to have a purified and dedicated channel, or energizer, for the love light of the infinite creator to flow through. Thus the initiatory method was necessary to prepare the mind, the body, and the spirit for service in the creator's work. The two are integral. Questioner, does the shape of the pyramid itself, is it a key function in the initiation process? This is a large question. We feel that we shall begin and ask you to reevaluate and ask further at a later session, this somewhat, shall we say, informative point. To begin, there are two main functions of the pyramid in relation to the initiatory procedures. One has to do with the body. Before the body can be initiated, the mind must be initiated. This is the point at which most adepts of your present cycle find their mind-body-spirit complexes distorted from. When the character and personality that is the true identity of the mind has been discovered, the body then must be known in each and every way. Thus, the various functions of the body need understanding and control with detachment. The first use of the pyramid, then, is the going down into the pyramid for purposes of deprivation of sensory input so that the body may, in a sense, be dead and another life begin. We advise, at this time, Any necessary questions and a fairly rapid ending of this session. Have you any query at this time, space questioner? The only question is there anything that we have done wrong, or anything that we could do to make the instrument more comfortable? We scan this instrument. This instrument has been much aided by these precautions. We suggest only some attention to the neck, which seems in this body distortion to be distorted in the area of strength weakness. More support, therefore, to the neck area may be an aid. Questioner, should we have her drink the water from the chalice behind her head after we charge it, or should we use a different glass of water? That and only the chalice shall be the most beneficial, as the virgin material living in the chalice accepts, retains, and responds to the love vibration activated by your beingness. I am raw. I will now leave this group rejoicing in the power and peace of the One Creator, Adonai. End of Session 3. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as Raw. Session 4. I am Raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner, finishing the last session, I had asked a question that was too long to answer. It had to do with the shape of the pyramid and its relationship to the initiation. Is this an appropriate time to ask this question? I am Raw. Yes, this is an appropriate time space to ask that question. Questioner, does the shape of the pyramid have effect upon the initiation? I am Raw. As we began the last session question, you have already recorded in your individual memory complex the first use of the shape having to do with the body complex initiation. The initiation of spirit was a more carefully designed type of initiation as regards the time-space ratios about which the entity to be initiated found itself. If you will picture with me the side of the so-called pyramid shape and mentally imagine this triangle cut into four equal triangles, you will find the intersection of the triangle, which is at the first level on each of the four sides, forms a diamond in a plane which is horizontal. The middle of this plane is the appropriate place for the intersection of the energies streaming from the infinite dimensions and the mind-body-spirit complexes of various interwoven energy fields. Thus it was designed that the one to be initiated would, by mind, be able to perceive and then channel this, shall we say, gateway to intelligent infinity. This, then, was the second point of designing this specific shape. May we provide a further description of any kind to your query? Questioner, as I understand it then, the initiate was to be on the center line of the pyramid, but at an altitude above the base as defined by the intersection of the four triangles made by dividing each side into four triangles. Is that correct? This is correct. Questioner, then at this point there is a focusing of energy that is extra-dimensional in respect to our dimensions. Am I correct? You may use that vibratory sound complex. However, it is not totally and specifically correct, as there are no extra dimensions. We would prefer the use of the term multi-dimensions. Questioner, is the size of the pyramid a function in effectiveness of the initiation? I am Raw. Each size pyramid has its own point of streaming in of intelligent infinity. Thus, a tiny pyramid that can be placed below a body or above a body will have specific and various effects depending upon the placement of the body in relationship to the entrance point of intelligent infinity. For the purposes of initiation, the size needed to be large enough to create the expression of towering size, so that the entrance point of multidimensional intelligent infinity would completely pervade and fill the channel, the entire body being able to rest in this focused area. Furthermore, it was necessary for healing purposes that both channel and the one to be healed be able to rest within that focused point. Questioner, is the large pyramid at Giza still usable for this purpose, or is it no longer functioning? I am Raw. That, like many other pyramid structures, is like the piano out of tune. It, as this instrument would express, plays the tune but, oh, so poorly. The disharmony jangles the sensitive. Only the ghost of the streaming still remains due to the shifting of the streaming points, which is in turn due to the shifting electromagnetic field of your planet. Due also to the discordant vibratory complexes of those who have used the initiatory and healing place for less compassionate purposes. Questioner, would it be possible to build a pyramid and properly align it and use it today, with materials we have available? I am Raw. It is quite possible for you to build a pyramid structure. The material used is not critical, merely the ratios of time-space complexes. However, the use of the structure for initiation and healing depends completely upon the inner disciplines of the channels attempting such work. Questioner, my question then would be, are there individuals incarnate upon the planet today who would have the necessary inner disciplines to, using your instructions, construct and initiate in a pyramid they built and then possibly do it again? Is this within limits of what anyone can do on the planet today, or is there no one available for this? I am raw. There are people, as you call them, who were able to take this calling at this nexus. However, we wish to point out once again that the time of the pyramids, as you would call it, is past. It is indeed a timeless structure. However, the streamings from the universe were, at the time we attempted to aid this planet, those which required a certain understanding of purity. This understanding has, as the streamings revolve and all things evolve, changed to a more enlightened view of purity. Thus, there are those among your people at this time whose purity is already one with intelligent infinity. Without the use of structures, healer patient can gain healing. May we further speak to some specific point? Questioner, is it possible for you to instruct healing techniques if we could make available these individuals that have the native ability? I am raw. It is possible. We must add that many systems of teach learning the healing patient nexus are proper given various mind-body-spirit complexes. We ask your imagination to consider the relative simplicity of the mind in the earlier cycle and the less distorted, but often overly complex, views and thought-spirit processes of the same mind-body-spirit complexes after many incarnations. We also ask your imagination to conceive of those who have chosen the distortion of service and have removed their mind-body-spirit complexes from one dimension to another, thus bringing with them and sometimes totally latent form many skills and understandings which more closely match the distortions of the healing patient processes. Questioner, I would very much like to continue investigation into the possibility of this healing process, but I'm a little lost as to where to begin. Can you tell me what my first step would be? I am raw. I cannot tell you what to ask. I may suggest that you consider the somewhat complex information just given and thus discover several avenues of inquiry. There is one health, as you call it, in your polarized environment, but there are several significantly various distortions of types of mind-body-spirit complexes. Each type must pursue its own learned teaching in this area. Questioner, I would assume that the first step would be to find an individual with ability brought with him into this incarnation. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, once I have selected an individual to perform healing, it would be helpful to receive instruction from you. Is this possible? I am raw. This is possible given the distortions of vibratory sound complexes. Questioner, I'm assuming, then, that the selected individual would necessarily be one who was very much in harmony with the law of one. Though he may not have any intellectual understanding of it, he should be living the law of one. Is this correct? I am raw. This is both correct and incorrect. The first case, that being correctness, would apply to one such as the questioner itself who has the distortion towards healing, as you call it. The incorrectness which shall be observed is the healing of those whose activities in your space-time illusion do not reflect the law of one, but whose ability has found its pathway to intelligent infinity regardless of the plane of existence from which this distortion is found. Questioner, aside, Jim, did you understand? I'm a little confused. I partially understood you. I'm not sure that I fully understood you. Could you restate that in another way? I can restate that in many ways. Given this instrument's knowledge of your vibratory sound complexes, I will strive for a shorter distortion at this time. Two kinds there are who can heal, those such as yourself who, having the innate distortion towards knowledge giving of the law of one, can heal but do not. And those who, having the same knowledge, but showing no significant distortion consciously towards the law of one in mind, body, or spirit, yet nevertheless have opened a channel to the same ability. The point being that there are those who, without proper training, shall we say, nevertheless, heal. It is a further item of interest that those whose life does not equal their work may find some difficulty in absorbing the energy of intelligent infinity and thus become quite distorted in such a way as to cause disharmony in themselves and others and perhaps even find it necessary to cease the healing activity. Therefore, those of the first type, those who seek to serve and are willing to be trained in thought, word, and action are those who will be able to comfortably maintain the distortion towards service in the area of healing. Questioner, then would it be possible for you to train us in healing practice? I am raw. It is possible. Questioner, will you train us? We will. Questioner, I have no idea of how long this would take or if you can even tell anything about that. Is it possible for you to give me a synopsis of the program of training required? I have no knowledge of what questions to ask at this point. I'll ask that question in the hopes that it makes sense. I am raw. We consider your request for information, for as you noted, There are a significant number of vibratory sound complexes which can be used in sequence to train the healer. The synopsis is a very appropriate entry that you might understand what is involved. Firstly, the mind must be known to itself. This is perhaps the most demanding part of healing work. If the mind knows itself, then the most important aspect of healing has occurred. For consciousness is the microcosm of the law of one. The second part has to do with the disciplines of the body complexes. In the streamings reaching your planet at this time, these understandings and disciplines have to do with the balance between love and wisdom and the use of the body in its natural functions. The third area is the spiritual, and in this area the first two disciplines are connected through the attainment of contact with intelligent infinity. Questioner, I believe I have some idea of the accomplishment, a little idea. Anyway, of the accomplishment, of the first step. Can you elaborate the steps, the other two steps I am not at all familiar with. I am raw. Imagine the body. Imagine the more dense aspects of the body. Proceed therefrom to the very finest knowledge of energy pathways which revolve and cause the body to be energized. Understand that all natural functions of the body have all aspects from dense to fine, and can be transmuted to what you may call sacramental. This is a brief investigation of the second area. To speak to the third, imagine, if you will, the function of the magnet. The magnet has two poles. One reaches up, the other goes down. The function of the spirit is to integrate the upreaching yearning of the mind-body energy with the downpouring and streaming of infinite intelligence. This is a brief explication of the third area. Questioner, then would this training program involve specific things to do, specific instructions and exercises? I am raw. We are not at this time incarnate among your peoples. Thus, we can guide and attempt to specify, but cannot, by example, show. This is an handicap. However, there should indeed be fairly specific exercises of mind, body, and spirit during the teach-learning process we offer. It is to be once again iterated that healing is but one distortion of the law of one. To reach an undistorted understanding of that law, it is not necessary to heal all, indeed, to show any manifestation, but only to exercise the disciplines of understanding. We would ask that one or two more questions be the ending of this session. Questioner, my objective is primarily to discover more of the law of one, and it would be very helpful to discover techniques of healing. I am aware of your problem with respect to free will. Can you make? You cannot make suggestions, so I will ask you if you can state the law of one and the laws of healing to me. I am raw. The law of one, though beyond the limitations of name, as you call vibratory sound complexes, may be approximated by stating that all things are one, that there is no polarity, no right or wrong, no disharmony, but only identity. All is one, and that one is love, light, light love, the infinite creator. One of the primal distortions of the law of one is that of healing. Healing occurs when a mind-body-spirit complex realizes, deep within itself, the law of one. That is, that there is no disharmony, no imperfection, that all is complete and whole and perfect. Thus, the intelligent infinity within this mind-body-spirit complex reforms the illusion of body, mind, or spirit to a form congruent with the law of one. The healer acts as energizer or catalyst for this completely individual process. One item which may be of interest is that a healer asking to learn must take the distortion understood as responsibility for that task receiving, thus healing. This is an honor duty which must be carefully considered in free will before the asking. Questioner, I assume that we should continue tomorrow. I am raw. Your assumption is correct unless you feel that a certain question is necessary. This instrument is best nurtured by approximately this length of work. Questioner, one short question. Is this instrument capable of two of these sessions per day, or should we remain with one? I am raw. This instrument is capable of two sessions a day. However, she must be encouraged to keep her bodily complex strong by the ingestion of your foodstuffs to an extent which exceeds this instrument's normal intake of your foodstuffs, this due to the physical material which we use to speak. Further, this instrument's activities must be monitored to prevent overactivity, for this activity is equivalent to a strenuous working on the physical level. If these admonitions are considered, the two sessions would be possible. We do not wish to deplete this instrument. Questioner, thank you. Raw, I am raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite intelligence which is the Creator. Go forth rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one Adonai. And obsession 4, the law of one. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as Raw. Session 5, I am raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner, the last time we communicated we were speaking of learning of healing. It is my impression that from what you gave to us in the earlier session that it is necessary to first purify the self by certain disciplines and exercises. Then in order to heal a patient, it is necessary, by example, and possibly certain exercises, to create a mental configuration in the patient that allows him to heal himself. Am I correct? I am raw. Although your learn understanding distortion is essentially correct, your choice of vibratory sound complex is not entirely as accurate as this language allows. It is not by example that the healer does the working. The working exists in and of itself. The healer is only the catalyst. Much as this instrument is the catalysis necessary to provide the channel for our words, yet by example or exercise of any kind can take no thought for this working. The healing working is congruent in that it is a form of channeling some distortion of the intelligent infinity. Questioner, we have decided to accept, if offered, the honor duty of learning teaching the healing process. I would ask as to the first step which we should accomplish in becoming effective healers. I am raw. We shall begin with the first of the three teachings learnings. We begin with the mental learn teachings necessary for contact with intelligent infinity. The prerequisite of mental work is the ability to retain silence of self at a steady state when required by the self. The mind must be opened like a door. The key is silence. Within the door lies an hierarchical construction you may liken unto geography and in some ways geometry, for the hierarchy is quite regular, bearing inner relationships. To begin to master the concept of mental discipline it is necessary to examine the self. The polarity of your dimension must be internalized. Where you find patience within your mind you must consciously find the corresponding impatience and vice versa. Each thought that a being has in its turn an antithesis. The disciplines of the mind involve, first of all, identifying both those things of which you approve and those things of which you disapprove within yourself, and then balancing each and every positive and negative charge with its equal. The mind contains all things. Therefore, you must discover this completeness within yourself. The second mental discipline is acceptance of the completeness within your consciousness. It is not for a being of polarity in the physical consciousness to pick and choose among attributes, thus building the roles that cause blockages and confusions in the already distorted mind complex. Each acceptance smooths part of the many distortions that the faculty you call judgment engenders. The third discipline of the mind is a repetition of the first, but with the gaze outward towards the fellow entities that it meets. In each entity there exists completeness. Thus, the ability to understand each balance is necessary. When you view patients, you are responsible for mirroring in your mental understanding patience, impatience. When you view impatience, it is necessary for your mental configuration of understanding to be impatience, patience. We use this as a simple example. Most configurations of mind have many facets, and understanding of either self-polarities, or what you would call other self-polarities, can and must be understood as subtle work. The next step is the acceptance of the other self-polarities, which mirrors the second step. These are the first four steps of learning mental discipline. The fifth step involves observing the geographical and geometrical relationships and ratios of the mind, the other mind, the mass mind, and the infinite mind. The second area of learned teaching is the study understanding of the body complexes. It is necessary to know your body well. This is a matter of using the mind to examine how the feelings, the biases, what you would call the emotions, affect various portions of the body complex. It shall be necessary to both understand the bodily polarities and to accept them, repeating in a chemical physical manifestation the work you have done upon the mind, bethinking the consciousness. The body is a creature of the mind's creation. It has its biases. The biological bias must be first completely understood and then the opposite bias allowed to find full expression in understanding. Again, the process of acceptance of the body is a balanced, as well as polarized, individual may then be accomplished. It is then the task to extend this understanding to the bodies of the other selves whom you will meet. The simplest example of this is the understanding that each biological male is female. Each biological female is male. This is a simple example. However, in almost every case wherein you are attempting the understanding of the body of self or other self, you will again find that the most subtle discernment is necessary in order to fully grasp the polarity complexes involved. At this time we would suggest closing the description until the next time of work so that we may devote time to the third area commensurate with its importance. We can answer a query if it is a short one before we leave this instrument. Questioner, is the instrument comfortable? Is there any other thing that would increase the instrument's comfort? That's all. I am raw. The candle could be rotated clockwise approximately 10 degrees each session to improve the flow of spiraled energy through the being's receiving mechanisms. This particular configuration is well otherwise, but we ask that the objects described and used be centered with geometric care and checked from time to time. Also that they not be exposed to that space-time in which work is not of importance. I am raw. I leave this instrument in the love and light of the one infinite creator. Go forth rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai. End of session 5. The law of one. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 6. I am RAW. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. I communicate now. Questioner, we would like to continue the material from yesterday. We had to cease before. Inaudible. I am raw. This is well with us. We proceed now with the third area of teach learning concerning the development of the energy powers of healing. The third area is the spiritual complex which embodies the fields of force and consciousness which are the least distorted of your mind-body-spirit complex. The exploration and balancing of the spirit complex is indeed the longest and most subtle part of your learned teaching. We have considered the mind as a tree. The mind controls the body. With the mind single-pointed, balanced, and aware, the body comfortable in whatever biases and distortions make it appropriately balanced for that instrument, the instrument is then ready to proceed with the great work. That is the work of wind and fire. The spiritual body energy field is a pathway, or channel. When body and mind are receptive and open, then the spirit can become a functioning shuttle or communicator from the entity's individual energy of will upwards, and from the streamings of the creative fire and wind downwards. The healing ability, like all other, what this instrument would call paranormal abilities, is affected by the opening of a pathway or shuttle into intelligent infinity. There are many upon your plane who have a random hole or gateway in their spirit energy field, sometimes created by the ingestion of chemicals such as what this instrument would call LSD, who were able, randomly and without control, to tap into energy sources. They may or may not be entities who wish to serve. The purpose of carefully and consciously opening this channel is to serve in a more dependable way, in a more commonplace or usual way, as seen by the distortion complex of the healer. To others there may appear to be miracles. To the one who has carefully opened the door to intelligent infinity, this is ordinary. This is commonplace. This is as it should be. The life experience becomes somewhat transformed and the great work goes on. At this time we feel these exercises suffice for your beginning. We will, at a future time, when you feel you have accomplished that which is set before you, begin to guide you into a more precise understanding of the functions and uses of this gateway in the experience of healing. Questioner, I've been asked if it is possible for Tom Flaherty to attend one of these communication sessions tomorrow. Are you familiar with the entity, Tom Flaherty? I am raw. This mind-body-spirit complex, sound vibration of Tom Flaherty, is acceptable. We caution you to carefully instruct this entity in the frame of mind and various appurtenances which it must understand before it is conducted into the circle. Questioner, I'm not quite sure what you meant by appurtenances. I was referring to the symbolic objects which trigger this instrument's distortions towards love light. The placement and loving acceptance of them by all present is important in the nurturing of this instrument. Therefore, the appurtenances involved must be described and their presence explained in your own words of teach learning, for you have the proper attitude for the required results. Questioner, he'll understand me. We'll be very careful to totally inform Tom before he attends. Thank you very much. It seems to me that it might be an appropriate time to include a little more historical background of yourself, possibly information having to do with where you came from prior to involvement with planet Earth, if this is possible. I am raw. I am, with the social memory complex of which I am a part, one of those who voyaged outward from another planet within your own solar system, as this entity would call it. The planetary influence was that you call Venus. We are a race old in your measures. When we were at the sixth dimension, our physical beings were what you would call golden. We were tall and somewhat delicate. Our physical body complex covering, which you call the integument, had a golden luster. In this form we decided to come among your peoples. Your peoples at that time were much unlike us in physical appearance, as you might call it. We, thus, did not mix well with the population and were obviously other than they. Thus, our visit was relatively short, for we found ourselves in the hypocritical position of being acclaimed as other than your other selves. This was the time during which we built the structures in which you show interest. Questioner, how did you journey from Venus to this planet? We used thought. Questioner, then you. Would it be possible to take one of the people at that time from our planet and place him on Venus? Would he survive? Were conditions much inaudible? The third density conditions are not hospitable to the life forms of your peoples. The fifth and sixth dimensions of that planetary sphere are quite conducive to growing, learning, teaching. Questioner, how were you able to make the transition from Venus, and I assume the sixth dimension, which would it be invisible when you reached here? Did you have to change your dimensions to walk on the Earth? You will remember the exercise of the wind. The dissolution into nothingness is the dissolution into unity, for there is no nothingness. From the sixth dimension, we are capable of manipulating, by thought, the intelligent infinity present in each particle of light or distorted light, so that we were able to clothe ourselves in a replica visible in the third density of our mind-body-spirit complexes in the sixth density. We were allowed this experiment by the council which guards this planet. Questioner, where is this council located? This council is located in the octave, or 8H, dimension, of the planet Saturn, taking its place in an area which you understand in third dimensional terms as the rings. Questioner, are there any people such as you find on Earth on any of the other planets in this solar system? Do you request space-time present information or space-time continuum information? Questioner, both. At one time space, in what is your past, there was a population of third density beings upon a planet which dwelt within your solar system. There are various names by which this planet has been named. The vibratory sound complex most usually used by your peoples is Moldek. These entities, destroying their planetary sphere, thus were forced to find room for themselves upon this third density, which is the only one in your solar system at their time space present which was hospitable and capable of offering the lessons necessary to decrease their mind-body-spirit distortions with respect to the law of one. Questioner, how did they come here? They came through the process of harvest and were incarnated through the processes of incarnation from your higher spheres within this density. Questioner, how long ago did this happen in our years? I am having difficulty communicating with this instrument. We must deepen her state. This occurred approximately 500,000 of your years ago. Questioner, thanks. Is all of the Earth's population then, human population of the Earth, are all of them originally from Moldek? I am raw. This is a new line of questioning, and deserves a place of its own. The ones who were harvested to your sphere from the sphere known before its dissolution as other names, but to your peoples as Moldek, incarnated, many within your Earth's surface rather than upon it. The population of your planet contains many various groups harvested from other second dimension and cycled third dimension spheres. You are not all one race or background of beginning. The experience you share is unique to this time-space continuum. Questioner, I think it would be appropriate to discover how the law of one acts in this transfer of beings to our planet and the action of harvest. I am raw. The law of one states simply that all things are one, that all beings are one. There are certain behaviors and thought forms consonant with the understanding and practice of this law. Those who, finishing a cycle of experience, demonstrate various grades of distortion of that understanding of thought and action will be separated by their own choice into the vibratory distortion most comfortable to their mind-body-spirit complexes. This process is guarded or watched by those nurturing beings who, being very close to the law of one and their distortions, nevertheless have the distortion towards active service. Thus, the illusion is created of light, or more properly but less understandably, light love. This is in varying degrees of intensity. The spirit complex of each harvested entity moves along the line of light until the light grows too glaring, at which time the entity stops. This entity may have barely reached third density or may be very, very close to the ending of the third density light love distortion vibratory complex. Nevertheless, those who fall within this octave of intensifying light love then experience a major cycle during which the opportunities are many for the discovery of the distortions which are inherent in each entity and, therefore, the lessening of these distortions. Questioner, what is the length, in our years, of one of these cycles currently? One major cycle is approximately 25,000. 25,000 of your years. There are three cycles of this nature during which those who have progressed may be harvested at the end of three major cycles. That is, approximately between 75 and 76,000, 75-76,000 of your years. All are harvested regardless of their progress, for during that time the planet itself has moved through the useful part of that dimension and begins to cease being useful for the lower levels of vibration within the density. Questioner, what is the position of this planet with respect to progression of the cycle at this time? I am Raw. This sphere is at this time in fourth dimension vibration. Its material is quite confused due to the society memory complexes embedded in its consciousness. It has not made an easy transition to the vibrations which beckon. Therefore, it will be fetched with some inconvenience. Questioner, is this inconvenience imminent within a few years? I am Raw. This inconvenience, or disharmonious vibratory complex, has begun several of your years in the past. It shall continue unabated for a period of approximately 30 of your years. Questioner, after this 30-year period I am assuming we will be a fourth dimensional fourth density planet. Is this correct? I am Raw. This is so. Questioner, is it possible to estimate what percentage of the present population will inhabit the fourth density planet? The harvesting is not yet, thus, estimation is meaningless. Questioner, does the fact that we are in this transition period now have anything to do with the reason that you have made your information available to the population? I am Raw. We have walked among your people. We remember sorrow. We have seen much. We have searched for an instrument of the proper parameters of distortion in mind-body-spirit complex and supporting and understanding group of mind-body-spirit complexes to accept this information with minimal distortion and maximal desire to serve for some of your years. The answer, in short, is yes. However, we wished you to know that in our memory we thank you. Questioner, the disc-shaped craft we call UFOs have been said to come possibly from the planet Venus. Would any of these be your craft? I am Raw. We have used crystals for many purposes. The craft of which you speak have not been used by us in your space-time present memory complex. However, we have used crystals and the bell shape in the past of your illusion. Questioner, how many years ago in the past did you use the bell-shaped craft to come here? I am Raw. We visited your peoples 18,000 of your years ago and did not land. Again, 11,000 years ago. Questioner, the photographs of the bell-shaped craft and reports of contact from Venus exist from less than 30 years ago. Do you have any knowledge of these reports? I am Raw. We have knowledge of oneness with these forays of your time space present. We are no longer a Venus. However, there are thought forms created among your peoples from our time of walking among you. The memory and thought forms created therefrom are a part of your society memory complex. This mass consciousness, as you may call it, creates the experience once more for those who request such experience. The present Venus population is no longer sixth density. Questioner, do any of the UFOs that are presently reported come from other planets here at this time, or do you have this knowledge? I am one of the members of the Confederation of Planets in the service of the Infinite Creator. There are approximately 53 civilizations, comprising approximately 500 planetary consciousness complexes in this confederation. This confederation contains those from your own planet who have attained dimensions beyond your third. It contains planetary entities within your solar system, and it contains planetary entities from other galaxies. It is a true confederation in that its members are not alike, but allied in service according to the law of one. Questioner, do any of them come here at this time in spacecraft? In the past, say, 30 years? I am Raw. We must state that this information is unimportant. If you will understand this, we feel that the information may be acceptably offered. The law of one is what we are here to express. However, we will speak upon this subject. Each planetary entity which wishes to appear within your third dimensional space-time distortion requests permission to break quarantine, as you may call it, and appear to your peoples. The reason and purpose for this appearance is understood and either accepted or rejected. There have been as many as 15 of the Confederation entities in your skies at any one time, the others available to you through thought. At present there are 7 which are operating with craft in your density. Their purposes are very simple: to allow those entities of your planet to become aware of infinity, which is often best expressed to the uninformed as the mysterious or unknown. Questioner, I am fully aware that you are primarily interested in disseminating the law of one. However, it is my judgment, could be wrong, that in order to disseminate this material it will be necessary to include questions such as the one I have just asked, for the purpose of creating the widest possible dissemination of the material. If this is not the objective, I could limit my questions only to the application of the law of one. But I understand that at this time it is the objective to widely disseminate this material. Is this correct? I am raw. This perception is only slightly distorted in your understand learning. We wish you to proceed as you deem proper. That is your place. We, in giving this information, find our distortion of understanding of our purpose to be that not only of the offering of information, but the weighting of it according to our distorted perceptions of its relative importance. Thus, you will find our statements, at times, to be those which imply that a question is unimportant. This is due to our perception that the given question is unimportant. Nevertheless, unless the question contains the potential for answer giving which may infringe upon free will, we offer our answers. Questioner, thank you very much. We do not want to overtire the instrument. It's now considerably over the normal working time. Could you tell me the condition of the instrument? The instrument is balanced due to your care. However, her physical vehicle is growing stiff. Questioner, in that case perhaps we should continue at a later time. We shall agree. Therefore, unless you have a short question we will take our leave. Questioner, the only question I have is that I must assume since Leonard was here when you first made contact, it'd be as suitable for him to be here as Tom. Is this correct? This is correct and completes the number of those at this time able to come who are suitable. Again, remember the instructions given for the preparation of the vibratory sound complex, Tom. I am raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai. End of session 6. The law of one. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as raw. Session 7. I am raw. I greet you in the love and the light of our infinite creator. I communicate now. Questioner, you mentioned that you were a member of the Confederation of Planets. What avenues of service, or types of service, are available to members of the Confederation? Would you describe some of them? I am raw. I am assuming that you intend the service which we of the Confederation can offer, rather than the service which is available to our use. The service available for our offering to those who call us is equivalent to the square of the distortion need of that calling divided by, or integrated with, the basic law of one and its distortion indicating the free will of those who are not aware of the unity of creation. Questioner, from this, I am assuming that the difficulty you have contacting this planet at this time is the mixture of people here, some being aware of the unity, some not, and for this reason you cannot come openly or give any proof of your contact. Is this correct? I am raw. As we just repeated through this instrument, we must integrate all of the portions of your social memory complex in its illusory disintegration form. Then the product of this can be seen as the limit of our ability to serve. We are fortunate that the law of service squares the desires of those who call. Otherwise, we would have no beingness in this time-space at this present continuum of the illusion. In short, you are basically correct. The thought of not being able is not a part of our basic thought form complex towards your peoples but rather is a maximal consideration of what is possible. Questioner, by squared, do you mean that if 10 people call you can count that, when comparing it to the planetary ratio of people, as 100 people, squaring 10, getting 100? Is that correct? I am raw. This is incorrect. The square is sequential 1, 2, 3, 4. Each squared by the next number. Questioner, inaudible use an example. If 10, only 10, entities on Earth required your services, how would you compute their call using this square rule? We would square 1/10 sequential times, raising the number to the 10th square. Questioner, what would be the result of this calculation? 24 second pause. The result is difficult to transmit. It is 1012. 1012. Approximately. The entities who call are sometimes not totally unified in their calling and, thus, the squaring is slightly less. Thus, there is a statistical loss over a period of call. However, perhaps you may see by this statistically corrected information the squaring mechanism. Questioner, about how many entities at present are calling from planet Earth for your services? I am called personally by 352,000. 352,000. The Confederation, in its entire spectrum of entity complexes, is called by 632 million of your mind-body-spirit complexes. These numbers have been simplified. Questioner, Can you tell me what the result of the application of the law of squares is to those figures? The number is approximately meaningless in the finite sense as there are many, many digits. It, however, constitutes a great calling which we of all creation feel and hear as if our own entities were distorted towards a great and overwhelming sorrow. It demands our service. Questioner, at what point would this calling be enough for you to openly come among the people on earth? How many entities on earth would have to call the Confederation? I am raw. We do not calculate the possibility of coming among your peoples by the numbers of calling, but by a consensus among an entire societal memory complex which has become aware of the infinite consciousness of all things. This has been possible among your peoples only in isolated instances. In the case wherein a social memory complex which is servant of the Creator sees this situation and has an idea for the appropriate aid which can only be done among your peoples, the social memory complex desiring this project lays it before the Council of Saturn. If it is approved, quarantine is lifted. Questioner, I have a question here, I believe, about that council from Jim. Who are the members, and how does the council function? I am raw. The members of the council are representatives from the Confederation and from those vibratory levels of your inner planes bearing responsibility for your third density. The names are not important because there are no names. Your mind-body-spirit complexes request names, and so, in many cases, the vibratory sound complexes which are consonant with the vibratory distortions of each entity are used. However, the name concept is not part of the council. If names are requested, we will attempt them. However, not all have chosen names. In number, the council that sits in constant session, though varying in its members by means of balancing, which takes place, what you would call irregularly, is 9. That is the session council. To back up this council, there are 24 entities which offer their services as requested. These entities faithfully watch and have been called the guardians. The council operates by means of what you would call telepathic contact with the oneness or unity of the 9, the distortions blending harmoniously so that the law of one prevails with ease. When a need for thought is present, the council retains the distortion complex of this need, balancing it as described, and then recommends what it considers as appropriate action. This includes 1. The duty of admitting social memory complexes to the Confederation. 2. Offering aid to those who are unsure how to aid the social memory complex, requesting aid in a way consonant with both the call, the law, and the number of those calling, that is to say, sometimes the resistance of the call. 3. Internal questions in the council are determined. These are the prominent duties of the council. They are, if in any doubt, able to contact the 24 who then offer consensus judgment thinking to the council. The council then may reconsider any question. Questioner, is the council of 9 the same 9 that was mentioned in this book? Questioner gestures to Yuri. I am raw. The council of 9 has been retained in semi-undistorted form by two main sources, that known in your naming as Mark and that known in your naming as Henry. In one case, the channel became the scribe. In the other, the channel was not the scribe. However, without the aid of the scribe, the energy would not have come to the channel. Questioner, the names you spoke of, are they Mark Probert and Henry Purick? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, I am interested in the application of the law of one as it pertains to free will and what I would call the advertising done by UFO contact with the planet. That is, the council has allowed the quarantine to be lifted many times over the past 30 years. This seems to me to be a form of advertising for what we are doing right now, so that more people will be awakened. Am I correct? I am raw. It will take a certain amount of untangling of conceptualization of your mental complex to reform your query into an appropriate response. Please bear with us. The Council of Saturn has not allowed the breaking of quarantine in the time-space continuum you mentioned. There is a certain amount of landing taking place. Some of these landings are of your peoples. Some are of the entities known to you as the Group of Orion. Secondly, there is permission granted, not to break quarantine by dwelling among you, but to appear in thought form capacity for those who have eyes to see. Thirdly, you were correct in assuming that permission was granted at the time-space in which your first nuclear device was developed and used for Confederation members to minister unto your peoples in such a way as to cause mystery to occur. This is what you mean by advertising and is correct. The mystery and unknown quality of the occurrences we are allowed to offer have the hoped-for intention of making your peoples aware of infinite possibility. When your peoples grasp infinity, then and only then, can the gateway be opened to the law of one. Questioner, You mentioned both our people and those of Orion coming here. Can you expand on that? I am raw. Your thought complexes did not match your vibratory sound complexes. We are unable to respond. Please restate your query. Questioner, I'll just ask about Orion. You mentioned Orion as a source of some of the contacts of UFOs. Can you tell me something of that contact? Its purpose? I am raw. Consider, if you will, a simple example of intentions which are bad good. This example is Adolf. This is your vibratory sound complex. The intention is to presumably unify by choosing the distortion complex called elite from a social memory complex and then enslaving, by various effects, those who are seen as the distortion of not elite. There is then the concept of taking the social memory complex thus weeded and adding it to a distortion thought of by the so-called Orion group as an empire. The problem facing them is that they face a great deal of random energy released by the concept of separation. This causes them to be vulnerable as the distortions amongst their own members are not harmonized. Questioner, what is the density of the Orion group? I am raw. Like the Confederation, the densities of the mass consciousnesses which comprise that group are varied. There are a very few third density, a larger number of fourth density, a similarly large number of fifth density, and very few sixth density entities comprising this organization. Their numbers are perhaps one-tenth as at any point in the space-time continuum, as the problem of spiritual entropy causes them to experience constant disintegration of their social memory complexes. Their power is the same as ours. The law of one blinks neither at the light or the darkness, but is available for service to others and service to self. However, service to others results in service to self, thus preserving and further harmonizing the distortions of those entities seeking intelligent infinity through these disciplines. Those seeking intelligent infinity through the use of service to self create the same amount of power but, as we said, have constant difficulty because of the concept of separation which is implicit in the manifestations of the service to self which involve power over others. This weakens and eventually disintegrates the energy collected by such mind-body-spirit complexes who call the Orion group and the social memory complexes which comprise the Orion group. It should be noted, carefully pondered, and accepted, that the law of one is available to any social memory complex which has decided to strive together for any seeking of purpose, be it service to others or service to self. The laws, which are the primal distortions of the law of one, then are placed into operation and the illusion of space-time is used as a medium for the development of the results of those choices freely made. Thus all entities learn, no matter what they seek. All learn the same, some rapidly, some slowly. Questioner, using as an example a fifth density group or social memory complex of the Orion group, what was their previous density before they became fifth density? I am raw. The progress through densities is sequential. A fifth density social memory complex would be comprised of mind-body-spirit complexes harvested from fourth density. Then the conglomerate or mass mind-body-spirit complex does its melding and the results are due to the infinitely various possibilities of combination of distortions. Questioner, I'm trying to understand how a group such as the Orion group would progress. I was of the opinion that a closer understanding of the law of one created the condition of acceptability moving say from our third density to the fourth in our transition now, and I'm trying to understand how it would be possible, if you were in the Orion group, and pointed towards self-service, how you would progress, say, from the third density to the fourth. What learning would be necessary for that? I am raw. This is the last question of length for this instrument at this time. You will recall that we went into some detail as to how those not oriented towards seeking service for others yet, nevertheless, found and could use the gateway to intelligent infinity. This is true at all densities in our octave. We cannot speak for those above us, as you would say, in the next quantum or octave of beingness. This is, however, true of this octave of densities. The beings are harvested because they can see and enjoy the light love of the appropriate density. Those who have found this light love, love light without benefit of a desire for service nevertheless, by the law of free will, have the right to the use of that light love for whatever purpose. Also, it may be inserted that there are systems of study which enable the seeker of separation to gain these gateways. This study is as difficult as the one which we have described to you, but there are those with the perseverance to pursue the study just as you desire to pursue the difficult path of seeking to know in order to serve. The distortion lies in the fact that those who seek to serve the self are seen by the law of one as precisely the same as those who seek to serve others. For are all not one? To serve yourself and to serve other is a dual method of saying the same thing, If you can understand the essence of the law of one, at this time we would answer any brief questions you may have. Questioner, is there anything we can do to make the instrument more comfortable? I am raw. There are small adjustments you may make. However, we are now able to use this instrument with minimal distortion and without depleting the instrument to any significant extent. Do you wish to ask further? Questioner, we do not wish to overly tire the instrument. Thank you very much. That was very helpful. We will continue in the next session taking up this point. I believe that I am beginning to understand the progression. Thank you very much. I am raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth then rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai. End of session 7. The law of one. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as raw. Session 8. I am raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. I communicate now. Questioner, I have a question about what I call the advertising of the Confederation. It has to do with free will. There have been certain contacts allowed, as I understand, by the Council, but this is limited because of free will of those who are not oriented in such a way that they could maybe want contact. This material that we are doing now will be disseminated. Dissemination of this material will be dependent upon the wants of a relatively small number of people on the planet. Many people on the planet now want this material, but even though we disseminate it, they will not be aware it is available. Is there any possibility of creating some effect which I would call advertising? Or is this against the principle of free will? I am raw. Consider, if you will, the path your life experience complex has taken. Consider the coincidences and odd circumstances by which one thing flowed to the next. Consider this well. Each entity will receive the opportunity that each needs. This information source beingness does not have users in the life experience complex of each of those among your peoples who seek. Thus the advertisement is general and not designed to indicate the searching out of any particular material, but only to suggest the noumenal aspect of the illusion. Questioner, there was a portion of the material yesterday which I will read where you say there is a certain amount of landing taking place. Some of these landings are of your peoples. Some are of the entities known to you as the group of Orion. My first question is, what did you mean by the landings are of your peoples? I am raw. Your peoples have, at this time, space present, the technological achievement, if you would call it that, of being able to create and fly the shape and type of craft known to you as unidentified flying objects. Unfortunately for the social memory complex vibratory rate of your peoples, these devices are not intended for the service of mankind, but for potential destructive use. This further muddles the vibratory nexus of your social memory complex, causing a situation whereby neither those oriented towards serving others nor those oriented towards serving self can gain the energy power which opens the gates to intelligent infinity for the social memory complex. This in turn causes the harvest to be small. Questioner, are these craft that are of our peoples from what we call planes that are not incarnate at this time? Where are they based? I am raw. These of which we spoke are of third density and are part of the so-called military complex of various of your people's societal divisions or structures. The bases are varied. There are bases, as you would call them, undersea in your southern waters near the Bahamas, as well as in your Pacific seas in various places close to your Chilean borders on the water. There are bases upon your moon, as you call the satellite, which are at this time being reworked. There are bases which move about your lands. There are bases, if you would call them that, in your skies. These are the bases of your peoples, very numerous and, as we have said, potentially destructive. Questioner, where do the people who operate these craft come from? Are they affiliated with any nation on Earth? What is their source? These people come from the same place as you or I. They come from the Creator. As you intend the question, in its shallower aspect, these people are those in your and other selves' governments responsible for what you would term national security. Questioner, am I to understand then that the United States has these craft in undersea bases? I am raw. You are correct. Questioner, how did the United States learn of the technology to build these land inaudible? I am raw. There was a mind-body-spirit complex known to your people by the vibratory sound complex, Nicola. This entity departed the illusion and the papers containing the necessary understandings were taken by mind-body-spirit complexes serving your security of national divisional complex. Thus your people became privy to the basic technology. In the case of those mind-body-spirit complexes which you call Russians, the technology was given from one of the Confederation in an attempt, approximately 27 of your years ago, to share information and bring about peace among your peoples. The entities giving this information were in error, but we did many things at the end of the cycle in attempts to aid your harvest, from which we learned the folly of certain types of aid. That is a contributing factor to our more cautious approach at this date, even as the need is power upon power greater, and your people's call is greater and greater. Questioner, I'm puzzled by these craft that we have undersea bases for. They are inaudible. Is this technology sufficient to overshadow all other armaments? Do we have just the ability to fly in these craft, or are there any weapons like there are? Were they given to us inaudible, or are they just craft for transport? What is the basic mechanism of their inaudible? It's really hard to believe is what I'm saying. I am raw. The craft are perhaps misnamed in some instances. It would be more appropriate to consider them as weaponry. The energy used is that of the field of electromagnetic energy which polarizes the Earth's sphere. The weaponry is of two basic kinds, that which is called by your people's psychotronic and that which is called by your people's particle beam. The amount of destruction which is contained in this technology is considerable, and the weapons have been used in many cases to alter weather patterns and to enhance the vibratory change which engulfs your planet at this time. Questioner, how have they been able to keep this a secret? Why aren't these craft in use for transport? The governments of each of your societal division illusions desire to refrain from publicity so that the surprise may be retained in case of hostile action from what your peoples call enemies. Questioner, how many of these craft does the United States have? I am raw. The United States has 573. At this time, they are in the process of adding to this number. Questioner, what is the maximum speed of one of these craft? I am raw. The maximum speed of these craft is equal to the Earth energy squared. This field varies. The limit is approximately one half the light speed, as you would call it. This is due to imperfections in design. Questioner, wouldn't this type of craft totally solve, or come close to solving, a lot of the energy problems as far as transport goes that we're used to transporting? Inaudible transporting, inaudible. I am raw. The technology your peoples possess at this time is capable of resolving each and every limitation which plagues your social memory complex at this present nexus of experience. However, the concerns of some of your beings with distortions towards what you would call powerful energy caused these solutions to be withheld until the solutions are so needed that those with the distortion can then become further distorted in the direction of power. Questioner, at the same time you mentioned that some of the landings were of our peoples, you also mentioned that some were of the Orion Group. We talked a little about the Orion Group, but why do the Orion Group land here? What is their purpose? I am raw. Their purpose is conquest, unlike those of the Confederation who wait for the calling. The so-called Orion Group calls itself to conquest. Questioner, specifically, what do they do when they land? There are two types of landings. In the first, entities among your peoples are taken on their craft and programmed for future use. There are two or three levels of programming. First, the level that will be discovered by those who do research. Second, a triggering program. Third, a second and most deep triggering program crystallizing the entity, thereby rendering it lifeless and useful as a kind of beacon. This is a form of landing. The second form is that of landing beneath the Earth's crust, which is entered from water. Again, in the general area of your South American and Caribbean areas and close to the so-called Northern Pole, the bases of these people are underground. Questioner, what do the Orion Group have? What's the objective with respect to the conquest of the Orion Group? I am raw. As we have said previously, their objective is to locate certain mind-body-spirit complexes which vibrate in resonance with their own vibrational complex, then to enslave the unelite, as you may call those who are not of the Orion vibration. Questioner, was the landing at Pascagoula in 1973 when Charlie Hickson was taken on board this type of landing? I am raw. The landing of which you speak was what you would call an anomaly. It was neither the Orion influence nor our peoples in thought form, but rather a planetary entity of your own vibration which came through quarantine in all innocence in a random landing. Questioner, what did they do to Charlie Hickson when they took him on board? I am raw. They used his mind-body-spirit complex's life experience, concentrating upon the experience of the complexes of what you call war. Questioner, how did they use them? I am raw. The use of experience is to learn. Consider a race who watches a movie. It experiences a story and identifies with the feelings, perceptions, and experiences of the hero. Questioner: was Charlie Hickson originally of the same social memory complex as the ones who picked him up? I am Raw. This entity of vibratory sound complex did not have a connection with those who used him. Questioner: did those who used him use his war experiences to learn more of the law of one? I am Raw. This is correct. Questioner: were the entities that picked him, can you describe as that the normal configuration of these entities? They, inaudible, rather unusual. I am Raw. The configuration of their beings is their normal configuration. The unusualness is not remarkable. We ourselves, when we chose a mission among your peoples, needed to study your peoples, for had we arrived in no other form than our own, we would have been perceived as light. Questioner: well, what density did the entities who picked up Charlie Hickson come from? What was their density? I am Raw. The entities in whom you show such interest are third density beings of a fairly high order. We should express the understanding to you that these entities would not have used the mind-body-spirit complex, Charlie, except for the resolve of this entity before incarnation to be of service. Questioner: what was the home or origin of the entities that took Charlie? I am Raw. These entities are of the Sirius galaxy. Questioner: the most startling information that you've given me, which I must admit I'm having difficulty believing, is that the United States has 573 craft like you describe. How many people in our government are aware that we have these? How many total people of United States designation are aware of this, including those who operate the craft? I am Raw. The number of your peoples varies, for there are needs to communicate at this particular time-space nexus, so that the number is expanding at this time. The approximate number is 1500. It is only approximate, for as your illusory time-space continuum moves from present to present at this nexus, many are learning. Questioner: where are these craft constructed? These craft are constructed one by one in two locations, in the desert or arid regions of your so-called New Mexico and in the desert or arid regions of your so-called Mexico, both installations being under the ground. Questioner: do you say the United States actually has a manufacturing plant in Mexico? I am Raw. I spoke thusly. May I, at this time, reiterate that this type of information is very shallow and of no particular consequence compared to the study of the law of one. However, we carefully watch these developments in hopes that your peoples are able to be harvested in peace. Questioner: I'm totally aware how this line of questioning is of no consequence at all, but this particular information is so startling to me that it makes me question your validity on this. Up until this point, I was in agreement with everything. This is very startling, and it does not seem possible that this secret could have been kept 27 years, and that we are operating these craft. I apologize for my attitude, but I thought I would be very honest about this. It is unbelievable to me that we would operate a plant in Mexico, outside of the United States, to build these craft. Maybe I'm mistaken. These craft are physical craft built by our physical people. I could go get in one and ride in one. Is that correct? I am Raw. This is incorrect. Who could not ride one? The United States, as you call your society divisional complex, creates these as a type of weapon. Questioner: there are no occupants then? No pilot, shall I say? I am Raw. This is correct. Questioner: how are they controlled? I am Raw. They are controlled by computer from a remote source of data. Questioner: why do we have a plant in Mexico? I am Raw. The necessity is both for dryness of the ground and for a near total lack of population. Therefore, your so-called government and the so-called government of your neighboring geographical vicinity arranged for an underground installation. The government officials who agreed did not know the use to which their land would be put, but thought it a governmental research installation for use in what you would call bacteriological warfare. Questioner: is this the type of craft that Dan Fry was transported in? I am Raw. The one known as Daniel was, in thought form, transported by Confederation thought form vehicular illusion in order to give this mind-body-spirit complex data, so that we might see how this type of contact aided your people in the uncovering of the intelligent infinity behind the illusion of limits. Questioner: would it be possible for any of us to have some type of contact with the Confederation in a more direct way? I am Raw. In observing the distortions of those who underwent this experiential sequence, we decided to gradually back off, shall I say, from direct contact in thought form. The least distortion seems to be available in mind-to-mind communication. Therefore, the request to be taken aboard is not one we care to comply with. You are most valuable in your present orientation. Questioner: The reason that I have questioned you so much upon the craft which you say the United States government operates is that if we include this in the book, it will create numerous problems. It is something that I am considering leaving out of the book entirely, or I am going to have to question you in considerable detail about it. It's difficult to even question in this area, but I would like maybe to ask a few more questions about it, with still the possible option of leaving it out of the book. What are the diameter of these craft the United States? Inaudible. I am raw. I suggest that this be the last question for this session. We will speak as you deem fit in further sessions, asking you to be guided by your own discernment only. The approximate diameter, given several model changes, is 23 of your feet, as you measure. May we ask at this time if you have a needed short query before we end the session? Questioner. Is there anything that we can do to make the instrument more comfortable? I am raw. The instrument is well balanced. It is possible to make small corrections in the configuration of the spine of the instrument that it be straighter. Continue also to carefully monitor the placement and orientation of the cymbals used. This particular session, the sensor is slightly off and, therefore, this instrument will experience a slight discomfort. Questioner. Is the sensor off with respect to angle or with respect to lateral displacement? There is an approximate 3-degree displacement from proper perpendicularity. I am raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai. End of session 8. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 9. I am RAW. I greet you in the love and the light of our infinite creator. We communicate now. Questioner, we are definitely going to make the Law of One the primary portion of this book. I apologize for getting sidetracked on these subjects. We're in the position of, shall we say, beating around as to what direction to go with the book to begin with. For this reason I have asked a few questions and probably will ask a few more questions in the early part of these sessions that will be somewhat meaningless with respect to application of the Law of One because my own ignorance what I'm doing. However, I expect to become more proficient rapidly while we go on. There are a couple of questions that are probably meaningless, but if I could get them out of the way, they're bothering me a little bit. Is it possible for you to suggest a publisher for this book? I am raw. No. Questioner, is it possible for you to tell us of anything in our past incarnations, our past experiences before this incarnation? I am raw. It is possible. However, such information as this is carefully guarded by your mind-body-spirit being totality so that your present space-time experiences will be undiluted. Let us scan for harmless material for your beingness. 22nd pause. I am, in the distortion of desire for your freedom from preconception, able to speak only generally. There have been several times when this group worked and dwelt together. The relationships varied. There is balanced karma, as you call it. Each thus the teacher of each. The work has involved healing, understanding the uses of the earth energy, and work in aid of civilizations which called just as your sphere has done and we have come. This ends the material which we consider harmless. Questioner, the healing exercises that you gave to us are of such a nature that it is best to concentrate on a particular exercise at a time. I would like to ask at this time what exercise I should concentrate on, possibly a little exercise change should concentrate on. Inaudible, Satanite. I am raw. Again, to direct your judgment is an intrusion upon your space-time continuum distortion called future. To speak of past or present within our distortion judgment limits is acceptable. To guide rather than teach learn is not acceptable to our distortion in regards to teach learning. We, instead, can suggest a process whereby each chooses the first of the exercises given in the order in which we gave them, which you, in your discernment, feel is not fully appreciated by your mind-body-spirit complex. This is the proper choice, building from the foundation, making sure the ground is good for the building. We have assessed for you the intensity of this effort in terms of energy expended. You will take this in mind and be patient, for we have not given a short or easy program of consciousness learn teaching. Questioner, the way I understand the process of evolution of a planetary population is that a population has a certain amount of time to progress. This is generally divided into 3 25,000-year cycles. At the end of 75,000 years, the planet progresses itself. What caused this situation to come about, preciseness of the years, 25,000 years, etc.? What set this up to begin with? I am raw. Visualize, if you will, the particular energy which, out upward flowing and inward coagulating, formed the tiny realm of the creation governed by your Council of Saturn. Continue seeing the rhythm of this process. The living flow creates a rhythm which is as inevitable as one of your timepieces. Each of your planetary entities began the first cycle when the energy nexus was able in that environment to support such mind-body experiences. Thus, each of your planetary entities is on a different cyclical schedule, as you might call it. The timing of these cycles is a measurement equal to a portion of intelligent energy. This intelligent energy offers a type of clock. The cycles move as precisely as a clock strikes your hour. Thus, the gateway from intelligent energy to intelligent infinity opens regardless of circumstance on the striking of the hour. Questioner, the original. The first entities on this planet, what was their origin? Where were they before they were on this planet? I am Ra. The first entities upon this planet were water, fire, air and earth. Questioner, the people that we now have, the first people, inaudible like us, where did they come from? How did they evolve? I am Ra. You speak of third density experience. The first of those to come here were brought from another planet in your solar system called by you the red planet, Mars. This planet's environment became inhospitable to third density beings. The first entities, therefore, were of this race, as you may call it, manipulated somewhat by those who were guardians at the time. Questioner, what race is that, and how did they get from Mars to here? I am Ra. The race is a combination of the mind-body-spirit complexes of those of your so-called red planet and a careful series of genetical adjustments made by the guardians of that time. These entities arrived, or were preserved, the experience upon your sphere by a type of birthing which is non-reproductive, but consists of preparing genetic material for the incarnation of the mind-body-spirit complexes of those entities from the red planet. Questioner, then I'm assuming what you're saying is that the guardians transferred the race here after the race had died from the physical as we know it on Mars. Is that correct? I am Ra. This is correct. Questioner, the guardians obviously were acting with an understanding of the law of one in doing this. Can you explain the application of the law of one in this process? I am Ra. The law of one was named by these guardians as the bringing of the wisdom of the guardians in contact with the entities from the red planet, thus melding the social memory complex of the guardian race and the red planet race. It, however, took an increasing amount of distortion into the application of the law of one from the viewpoint of other guardians, and it is from this beginning action that the quarantine of this planet was instituted, for it was felt that the free will of those of the red planet had been abridged. Questioner, were the entities of the red planet following the law of one prior to leaving the red planet? The entities of the red planet were attempting to learn the laws of love, which form one of the primal distortions of the law of one. However, the tendencies of these people towards bellicose actions caused such difficulties in the atmospheric environment of their planet that it became inhospitable for third density experience before the end of its cycle. Thus, the red planet entities were unharvested and continued in your illusion to attempt to learn the law of love. Questioner, how long ago did this transfer occur from the red planet to Earth? I am Ra. In your time, this transfer occurred approximately 75,000 years ago. Questioner, 75,000 years ago? I am Ra. This is approximately correct. Questioner, were there any entities of this form that I am now, two arms, two legs, on this planet before this transfer occurred? I am Ra. There have been visitors to your sphere at various times for the last 4 million of your years, speaking approximately. These visitors do not affect the cycling of the planetary sphere. It was not third density in its environment until the time previously mentioned. Questioner, then there were second density entities here prior to approximately 75,000 years ago. What type of entities were these? The second density is the density of the higher plant life and animal life which exists without the upward drive towards the infinite. These second density beings are of an octave of consciousness, just as you find various orientations of consciousness among the conscious entities of your vibration. Questioner, did any of these second density entities have shapes like ours, two arms, two legs, head, and walk upright on 2 feet? I am Ra. The two higher of the sub-vibrational levels of second density beings had the configuration of the biped, as you mentioned. However, the erectile movement which you experience was not totally affected, and these beings who were tending towards the leaning forward, barely leaving the quadrupedal position. Questioner, where did these beings come from? Were they a product of evolution as it is understood by our scientists? Were they evolved from the original material of the Earth that you spoke of? I am Ra. This is correct. Questioner, do these beings then evolve from second density to third density? I am Ra. This is correct. although no guarantee can be made of the number of cycles it will take an entity to learn the lessons of consciousness of self, which are the prerequisite for transition to third density. Questioner: is there any particular race of people on our planet now who are incarnated here from second density? I am Raw. There are no second density consciousness complexes here on your sphere at this time. However, there are two races which use the second density form. One is the entities of the planetary sphere you call Moldek. These entities are working their understanding complexes through a series of what you would call karmic restitutions. They dwell within your deeper underground passageways and are known to you as Bigfoot. The other race is that being offered a dwelling in this density by guardians who wish to give the mind-body-spirit complexes of those who were of this density at this time appropriately engineered physical vehicles, as you would call these chemical complexes, in the event that there is what you call nuclear war. Questioner: I didn't understand what these vehicles or beings were for that were appropriate in the event of nuclear war. I am Raw. These are beings which exist as instinctual second density beings which are being held in reserve to form what you would call a gene pool in case these body complexes are needed. These body complexes are greatly able to withstand the rigors of radiation which the body complexes you now inhabit could not do. Questioner: where are these body complexes located? I am Raw. These body complexes of the second race dwell in uninhabited deep forest. There are many in various places over the surface of your planet. Questioner: are they Bigfoot-type creatures? I am Raw. This is correct, although we would not call these Bigfoot, as they are scarce and are very able to escape detection. The first race is less able to be aware of proximity of other mind-body-spirit complexes, but these beings are very able to escape due to their technological understandings before their incarnations here. These entities of the glowing eyes are those most familiar to your peoples. Questioner: then there are two different types of Bigfoot. Correct. I am Raw. This will be the final question. There are three types of Bigfoot. If you will accept that vibratory sound complex used for three such different races of mind, body, spirit complexes. The first two we have described. The third is a thought form. Questioner: we plan to do a second session later today if the instrument is capable, and I'd like to ask, believe this is possible, and also if there is anything we can do to aid the instrument's comfort. I am Raw. This instrument will require some adjustment of the tender portions of her body complex. The distortions are due to the energy center blockage you would call pineal. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the One Creator, Adonai. End of Session 9. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and Registered Trademark and the Social Memory Complex, known as Raw. Session 10. I am Raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner: I think it would clarify things for us to go back to the time just before the transfer of souls from Moldek. See how the Law of One operated with respect to this transfer and why this was necessary. What happened to Moldek or the people on Moldek to cause them to lose their planet? How long ago did this occur? I am Raw. The peoples of Moldek had a civilization somewhat similar to that of the societal complex known to you as Atlantis, in that it gained much technological information and used it without care for the preservation of their sphere, following to a majority extent the complex of thought, ideas, and actions which you may associate with your so-called negative polarity or the service to self. This was, however, for the most part, couched in a sincere belief thought structure which seemed to the perception of the mind-body complexes of this sphere to be positive and of service to others. The devastation that wracked their biosphere and caused its disintegration resulted from what you call war. The escalation went to the furthest extent of the technology this social complex had at its disposal in the space-time present of the then time. This time was approximately 705,000 of your years ago. The cycles had begun much earlier upon this sphere due to its relative ability to support the first dimensional life forms at an earlier point in the space-time continuum of your solar system. These entities were so traumatized by this occurrence that they were in what you may call a social complex knot or tangle of fear. Some of your time passed. No one could reach them. No beings could aid them. Approximately 600,000 600,000 of your years ago, the then existing members of the Confederation were able to deploy a social memory complex and untie the knot of fear. The entities were then able to recall that they were conscious. This awareness brought them to the point upon what you would call the lower astral planes, where they could be nurtured until each mind-body-spirit complex was able finally to be healed of this trauma, to the extent that each entity was able to examine the distortions it had experienced in the previous life illusion complex. After this experience of learned teaching, the group decision was to place upon itself a type of what you may call karma alleviation. For this purpose, they came into incarnation within your planetary sphere in what were not acceptable human forms. This then they have been experiencing until the distortions of destruction are replaced by distortions towards the desire for a less distorted vision of service to others. Since this was the conscious decision of the great majority of those beings in the Moldek experience, the transition to this planet began approximately 500,000 of your years ago, and the type of body complex available at that time was used. Questioner: was the body complex available at that time what we refer to as the ape type? That is correct. Questioner: and have any of the Moldek entities transformed now? Are they now still second density, or are they forming some third density planet now? The consciousness of these entities has always been third density. The alleviation mechanism was designed by the placement of this consciousness in second dimensional physical chemical complexes, which are not able to be dexterous or manipulative to the extent which is appropriate to the workings of the third density distortions of a mind complex. Questioner: well, have any of these entities moved on now, made a, shall we say, graduation at the end of a 75-year cycle and gotten out of the second density body into third density type bodies? I am raw. Many of these entities were able to remove the accumulation of what you call karma, thus being able to accept a third density cycle within a third density body. Most of those beings so succeeding have incarnated elsewhere in the creation for the succeeding cycle in third density. As this planet reached third density, some few of these entities became able to join the vibration of this sphere in the third density form. There remain a few who have not yet alleviated through the mind-body-spirit coordination of distortions the previous action taken by them. Therefore, they remain. Questioner: are these the Bigfoot you spoke of? I am raw. These are one type of Bigfoot. Questioner: then our present race is formed of a few who originally came from Moldek and quite a few who came from Mars. Are there entities here from other places? I am raw. There are entities experiencing your time-space continuum who have originated from many, many places, as you would call them, in the creation, for when there is a cycle change, those who must repeat then find a planetary sphere appropriate for this repetition. It is somewhat unusual for a planetary mind-body-spirit complex to contain those from many, many, various loci, but this explains much, for, you see, you are experiencing the third dimensional occurrence with a large number of those who must repeat the cycle. The orientation, thus, has been difficult to unify even with the aid of many of your teach learners. Questioner: when Moldek was destroyed, did all people of Moldek have the problem, or were some advanced enough to transfer to other planets? I am raw. In the occurrence of planetary dissolution, none escaped, for this is an action which redounds to the social complex of the planetary complex itself. None escaped the knot or tangle. Questioner: is there any danger of this happening to Earth at this time? I am raw. We feel this evaluation of your planetary mind-body-spirit complex's so-called future may be less than harmless. We say only the conditions of mind exist for such development of technology and such deployment. It is the distortion of our vision understanding that the mind and spirit complexes of those of your people need orientation rather than the toys needing dismantlement, for are not all things that exist part of the Creator? Therefore, freely to choose is your honor duty. Questioner: when a graduation occurs, and an entity or entities move, at the end of a cycle from one planet to another, by what means do they go from one planet to the other? I am raw. In the scheme of the Creator, the first step of the mind-body-spirit totality beingness is to place its mind-body-spirit complex distortion in the proper place of love-light. This is done to ensure proper healing of the complex and eventual attunement with the totality beingness complex. This takes a very variable length of your time-space. After this is accomplished, the experience of the cycle is dissolved and filtered until only the distillation of distortions in its pure form remains. At this time, the harvested mind-body-spirit totality beingness evaluates the density needs of its beingness and chooses the more appropriate new environment for either a repetition of the cycle or a moving forward into the next cycle. This is the manner of the harvesting, guarded and watched over by many. Questioner, when the entity is moved from one planet to the next, is he moved in thought or in a vehicle? I am raw. The mind-body-spirit totality beingness is one with the creator. There is no time-space distortion. Therefore, it is a matter of thinking the proper locus in the infinite array of time-spaces. Questioner, while an entity is incarnate in this third density at this time, he may either learn without consciously knowing what he's doing, or he may learn after he is consciously aware that he is learning in the ways of the law of one. The second way, it is possible for the entity to greatly accelerate his growth. Is not this correct? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, then although many entities are not aware of this, what they really desire is to accelerate their growth, and it is their job to discover this while incarnate. Is it correct that they can accelerate their growth much more while incarnate in third density than in between incarnations of this density? I am raw. This is correct. We shall attempt to speak upon this concept. The law of one has as one of its primal distortions the free will distortion, thus each entity is free to accept, reject, or ignore the mind-body-spirit complexes about it and ignore the creation itself. There are many among your social memory complex distortion who, at this time-space, engage daily, as you would put it, in the working upon the law of one in one of its primal distortions. That is, the ways of love. However, if this same entity, being biased from the depths of its mind-body-spirit complex towards love-light, were then to accept responsibility for each moment of the time-space accumulation of present moments available to it, such an entity can empower its progress in much the same way as we describe the empowering of the call of your social complex distortion to the Confederation. Questioner, would you state in a little different way how you empower this call? I am raw. We understand you to speak now of our previous information. The call begins with one. This call is equal to infinity and is not, as you would say, counted. It is the cornerstone. The second call is added. The third call empowers or doubles the second, and so forth. Each additional call a doubling or granting power to all the preceding call. Thus, the call of many of your peoples is many, many powered and overwhelmingly heard to the infinite reaches of the one creation. Questioner, for general development of the reader of this book, could you state some of the practices or exercises to perform to produce an acceleration toward the law of one? I am raw. Exercise 1. This is the most nearly centered and usable within your illusion complex. The moment contains love. That is the lesson goal of this illusion or density. The exercise is to consciously seek that love and awareness and understanding distortions. The first attempt is the cornerstone. Upon this choosing rests the remainder of the life experience of an entity. The second seeking of love within the moment begins the addition. The third seeking powers the second, the fourth powering or doubling the third. As with the previous type of empowerment, there will be some loss of power due to flaws within the seeking and the distortion of insincerity. However, the conscious statement of self to self of the desire to seek love is so central and actable that, as before, the loss of power due to this friction is inconsequential. Exercise 2. The universe is one being. When a mind-body-spirit complex views another mind-body-spirit complex, see the creator. This is an helpful exercise. Exercise 3. Gaze within a mirror. See the creator. Exercise 4. Gaze at the creation which lies about the mind-body-spirit complex of each entity. See the creator. The foundation or prerequisite of these exercises is a predilection towards what may be called meditation, contemplation, or prayer. With this attitude, these exercises can be processed. Without it, the data will not sink down into the roots of the tree of mind, thus enabling and ennobling the body and touching the spirit. Questioner, I was wondering about the advent of the civilization called Atlantis and Lemuria, the way these civilizations occurred, and where did they come from? Inaudible civilizations? I am raw. This is the last question of this work. The civilizations of Atlantis and Lemuria were not one but two. Let us look first at the new entities. They were beings of a somewhat primitive nature, but those who had very advanced spiritual distortions. The civilization was part of this cycle, experienced early within the cycle at a time of approximately 53,000 of your years ago. It was an helpful and harmless place which was washed beneath the ocean during a readjustment of your sphere's tectonic plates through no action of their own. They set out those who survived and reached many places in what you call Russia, North America, and South America. The Indians of whom you have come to feel some sympathy in your social complex distortions are the descendants of these entities. Like the other incarnates of this cycle, they came from elsewhere. However, These particular entities were largely drawn from a second density planet which had some difficulty, due to the age of his son, in achieving third density life conditions. This planet was from the galaxy Denb. The Atlantean race was a very conglomerate social complex which began to form approximately 31,000 years in the past of your space-time continuum illusion. It was a slow-growing and very agrarian society until approximately 15,000 of your years ago. It reached quickly a high technological understanding which caused it to be able to use intelligent infinity in a less informative manner. We may add that they used intelligent energy as well, manipulating greatly the natural influxes of the indigo or pineal ray from divine or infinite energy. Thus, they were able to create life forms. This they began to do instead of healing and perfecting their own mind-body-spirit complexes, turning their distortions towards what you may call the negative. Approximately 11,000 of your years ago, the first of the, what you call, wars, caused approximately 40% of this population to leave the density by means of disintegration of the body. The second and most devastating of the conflicts occurred approximately 10,821 years in the past according to your illusion. This created an earth-changing configuration and the large part of Atlantis was no more, having been inundated. Three of the positively oriented of the Atlantean groups left this geographical locus before that devastation, placing themselves in the mountain areas of what you call Tibet, what you call Peru, and what you call Turkey. Do you have any brief questions before we close this meeting? Questioner, only one, other than what we can do to make the instrument more comfortable. I have only one other question. I would like to have brief information of the word you use, galaxy. I am Raw. We use the term known to your people by the sound vibration complex galaxy. We accept that some galaxies contain one system of planetary and solar groups, others containing several. However, the importance of the locus in infinite time-space dimensionality is so little that we accept the distortion implicit in such an ambiguous term. Questioner, then would 9 planets and our sun we have here in our system, would you refer to that as a solar galaxy? We would not. Questioner, how many stars, approximately, would be in a galaxy? It depends upon the galactic system. Your own, as you know, contains many, many millions of planet entities and star bodies. Questioner, I was just trying to get to the definition you were using for galaxy. You mentioned them a couple of times and it seemed to me that, inaudible what you call a galaxy we call a planetary system. Is there any way to make the instrument more comfortable? I am Raw. This instrument could be made somewhat more comfortable if more support were given the body complex. Other than this, we can only repeat the request to carefully align the symbols used to facilitate this instrument's balance. Our contact is narrow-banded and thus the influx brought in with us must be precise. I am Raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the One Infinite Creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the One Creator. Adonai. And of Session 10. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as Raw. Session 11. I am Raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner, should we include the ritual that you have suggested that we use to call you in the book that will result from these sessions? I am Raw. This matter is of small importance for our suggestion was made for the purpose of establishing contact through this instrument with this group. Questioner, is it of any assistance to the instrument to have name and name present during these sessions? Does the number in the group make any difference in these sessions? I am Raw. The most important of the entities are the questioner and the vibratory sound complex, Jim. The two entities additional aid the instrument's comfort by energizing the instrument with their abilities to share the physical energy complex which is a portion of your love vibration. Questioner, you said yesterday that Moldek was destroyed due to warfare. If Moldek hadn't destroyed itself due to warfare, would it have become a planet that evolved with self-service and would the entities have increased in density, gone on to say the fourth, fifth density in the negative sense or the sense of self-service? I am Raw. The planetary social memory complex, Moldek, had in common with your own sphere the situation of a mixture of energy direction. Thus it, though unknown, would most probably have been a mixed harvest, a few moving to fourth density, a few moving towards fourth density in service to self, the great majority repeating third density. This is approximate due to the fact that parallel possibility probability vortices cease when action occurs and new probability possibility vortices are begun. Questioner, is there a planet behind our sun, opposite to us in orbit, that we do not know about? I am raw. There is a sphere in the area opposite your sun of a very, very cold nature, but large enough to skew certain statistical figures. This sphere should not properly be called a planet as it is locked in first density. Questioner, you said that entities from Moldec might go to some may go to fourth density negative. Are there people who go out of our present third density to places in the universe and serve, which are fourth density self-service or negative type of planets? I am raw. Your question is unclear. Please restate. Questioner, as our cycle ends and graduation occurs, is it possible for anyone to go from this third density to a fourth density planet that is a self-service type or negative type? I am raw. We grasp now the specificity of your query. In this harvest, the probability possibility vortex indicates an harvest, though small, of this type. That is correct. Questioner, can you tell us what happened to Adolf Hitler? I am raw. The mind-body-spirit complex known as Adolf is at this time in an healing process in the middle astral planes of your spherical force field. This entity was greatly confused and, although aware of the circumstance of change in vibratory level associated with the cessation of the chemical body complex, nevertheless, needed a great deal of care. Questioner, is there anyone in our history that is commonly known who went to a fourth density self-service or negative type planet or who will go there? I am raw. The number of entities thus harvested is small. However, a few have penetrated the eighth level, which is only available from the opening up of the seventh through the sixth. Penetration into the eighth or intelligent infinity level allows a mind-body-spirit complex to be harvested if it wishes at any time space during the cycle. Questioner, are any of these people known in the history of our planet by name? I am raw. We will mention a few. The one known as Taras Bulba, the one known as Genghis Khan, the one known as Rasputin. Questioner, how did they accomplish this? What was necessary for them to accomplish this? All of the aforementioned entities were aware, through memory, of Atlantean understandings having to do with the use of the various centers of mind, body, spirit, complex, energy and flux in attaining the gateway to intelligent infinity. Questioner, did this enable them to do what we refer to as magic? Do paranormal things while they were incarnate here? I am raw. This is correct. The first two entities mentioned made little use of these abilities consciously. However, they were bent single-mindedly upon service to self, sparing no efforts in personal discipline to double, redouble and so empower this gateway. The third was a conscious adept and also spared no effort in the pursuit of service to self. Questioner, where are these three entities now? I am raw. These entities are in the dimension known to you as fourth. Therefore the space-time continua are not compatible. An approximation of the space-time locus of each would net no actual understanding. Each chose a fourth density planet which was dedicated to the pursuit of the understanding of the law of one through service to self, one in what you know as the Orion Group, one in what you know as Cassiopeia, one in what you know as Southern Cross. However, these loci are not satisfactory. We do not have vocabulary for the geometric calculations necessary for transfer of this understanding to you. Questioner, who went to the Orion Group? I am raw. The one known as Genghis Khan. Questioner, what does he presently do there? What is his job or occupation? What does he do? I am raw. This entity serves the Creator in its own way. Questioner, is it impossible for you to tell us precisely how he does this service? I am raw. It is possible for us to speak to this query. However, we use any chance we may have to reiterate the basic understanding learning that all beings serve the Creator. The one you speak of as Genghis Khan, at present, is incarnate in a physical light body which has the work of disseminating material of thought control to those who are what you may call crusaders. He is, as you would term this entity, a shipping clerk. Questioner, what do the crusaders do? I am raw. The crusaders move in their chariots to conquer planetary mind-body-spirit social complexes before they reach the stage of achieving social memory. Questioner, at what stage does a planet achieve social memory? I am raw. A mind-body-spirit social complex becomes a social memory complex when its entire group of entities are of one orientation or seeking. The group memory lost to the individuals in the roots of the tree of mind then become, S, known to the social complex, thus creating a social memory complex. The advantages of this complex are the relative lack of distortion in understanding the social beingness and the relative lack of distortion in pursuing the direction of seeking, For all understanding distortions are available to the entities of the society. Questioner, then we have crusaders from Orion coming to this planet for mind control purposes. How do they do this? As all, they follow the law of one observing free will. Contact is made with those who call. Those then upon the planetary sphere act much as do you to disseminate the attitudes and philosophy of their particular understanding of the law of one, which is service to self. These become the elite. Through these, the attempt begins to create a condition whereby the remainder of the planetary entities are enslaved by their own free will. Questioner, can you name any of the recipients of the crusaders, that is, any names that may be known on the planet today? I am Raw. I am desirous of being in non-violation of the free will distortion. To name those involved in the future of your space-time is to infringe. Thus, we withhold this information. We request your contemplation of the fruits of the actions of those entities whom you may observe enjoying the distortion towards power. In this way you may discern for yourself this information. We shall not interfere with a, shall we say, planetary gain. It is not central to the harvest. Questioner, how do the crusaders pass on their concepts to the incarnate individuals on Earth? I am Raw. There are two main ways, just as there are two main ways of, shall we say, polarizing towards service to others. There are those mind-body-spirit complexes upon your plane who do exercises and perform disciplines in order to seek contact with sources of information and power leading to the opening of the gate to intelligent infinity. There are others whose vibratory complex is such that this gateway is open and contact with total service to self with its primal distortion of manipulation of others is then afforded with little or no difficulty, no training, and no control. Questioner, what type of information is passed on from the crusaders to these people? I am Raw. The Orion group passes on information concerning the law of one with the orientation of service to self. The information can become technical just as some in the Confederation, in attempts to aid this planet in service to others, have provided what you would call technical information. The technology provided by this group is in the form of various means of control or manipulation of others to serve the self. Questioner, do you mean then that some scientists receive technical information, shall we say, telepathically that comes out then as usable gadgetry? I am Raw. That is correct. However, very positively, as you would call this distortion, oriented so-called scientists have received information intended to unlock peaceful means of progress which redounded onto the last echoes of potential destruction due to further reception of other scientists of a negative orientation distortion. Questioner, is this how we learned of nuclear energy? Was it mixed, both positive and negative orientation? I am Raw. This is correct. The entities responsible for the gathering of the scientists were of a mixed orientation. The scientists were overwhelmingly positive in their orientation. The scientists who followed their work were of mixed orientation, including one extremely negative entity, as you would term it. Questioner, is this extremely negative entity still incarnate on Earth? I am Raw. This is correct. Questioner, then I assume you can't name him and would ask you where Nikola Tesla got his information? I am Raw. The one known as Nikola received information from Confederation sources desirous of aiding this extremely, shall we say, angelically positive entity in bettering the existence of its fellow mind-body-spirit complexes. It is unfortunate, shall we say, that like many wanderers the vibratory distortions of third density illusion caused this entity to become extremely distorted in its perceptions of its fellow mind-body-spirit complexes so that its mission was hindered and in the result, perverted from its purposes. Questioner, how was Tesla's work supposed to benefit man on Earth, and what were its purposes? I am Raw. The most desired purpose of the mind-body-spirit complex, Nikola, was the freeing of all planetary entities from darkness. Thus, it attempted to give to the planet the infinite energy of the planetary sphere for use in lighting and power. Questioner, by freeing the planetary entities from darkness, precisely what do you mean? I am Raw. Most of the following answer was lost due to tape recorder malfunction. The core of the response was as follows. We spoke of freeing people from darkness in a literal sense. Questioner, would this freeing from darkness be commensurate with the law of one, or does this have any real product? I am Raw. The product of such a freeing would create two experiences. Firstly, the experience of no need to find the necessary emolument for payment, in your money, for energy. Secondly, the leisure afforded, thereby exemplifying the possibility and enhancing the probability of the freedom to then search the self for the beginning of seeking the law of one. Few there are working physically from daybreak to darkness, as you name them, upon your plane who can contemplate the law of one in a conscious fashion. Questioner, What about the Industrial Revolution in general? Was this planned in any way? I am Raw. This will be the final question of this session. That is correct. Wanda is incarnated in several waves, as you may call them, in order to bring into existence the gradual freeing from the demands of the diurnal cycles and lack of freedom of leisure. Questioner, well, that was the last question, so I will as usual ask if there's anything we can do to make the instrument more comfortable. I am Raw. You are doing well. The most important thing is to carefully align the symbols. The adjustment made this particular time-space present will aid this instrument's physical complex in the distortion towards comfort. May we ask if you have any short questions which we may resolve before closing the session? Questioner, I don't know if this is a short question or not, so we can save it till next time. But my only question is why the Crusaders from Orion do this. What is their ultimate objective? This is probably too long to answer. I am Raw. This is not too long to answer. To serve the self is to serve all. The service of the self, when seen in this perspective, requires an ever-expanding use of the energies of others for manipulation to the benefit of the self with distortion towards power. If there are further queries to more fully explicate this subject, we shall be with you again. Questioner, just was one thing I forgot. Is it possible to do another session late today? I am Raw. It is well. Questioner, thank you. I am Raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the One Infinite Creator. Go forth, then, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the One Creator. Adonai. End of Session 11. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as Raw. Session 12. I am Raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner, I got a call from Henry Purick this afternoon. He will be here next month. I want to ask you if it is possible for him to join in our circle and ask questions. And also if Michelle Dobranovic, who's also known as George Hunt Williamson, happens to come here, would it be alright for him to be in the circle? I am Raw. These entities, at present, are not properly attuned for the particular work due to vibrational distortions, which in turn are due to a recent lack of time-space which you call busyness. It would be requested that the entities spend a brief time-space in each diurnal cycle of your planet in contemplation. At a future time-space in your continuum, you are requested to ask again. This group is highly balanced to this instrument's vibratory distortions due to, firstly, contact with the instrument on a day-to-day basis. Secondly, due to contact with the instrument through meditation periods. Thirdly, through a personal mind-body-spirit complex distortion towards contemplation, which in some causes this group to be effective. Questioner, thank you. Continuing with the previous session, you mentioned that the Orion Crusaders came here in chariots. Could you describe a chariot? I am Raw. The term chariot is a term used in warfare among your peoples. That is its significance. The shape of the Orion craft is one of the following. Firstly, the elongated, ovoid shape, which is of a darker nature than silver but which is a metallic appearance if seen in the light. In the absence of light, it appears to be red or fiery in some manner. Other craft include disc-shaped objects of a small nature, approximately 12 feet in your measurement in diameter, the box-like shape approximately 40 feet to a side in your measurement. Other craft can take on a desired shape through the use of thought control mechanisms. There are various civilization complexes which work within this group. Some are more able to use intelligent infinity than others. The information is very seldom shared. Therefore, the chariots vary greatly in shape and appearance. Questioner, is there any effort by the Confederation to stop the Orion chariots from arriving here? I am Raw. Every effort is made to quarantine this planet. However, the network of guardians, much like any other pattern of patrols on whatever level, does not hinder each and every entity from penetrating quarantine, for if request is made in light love, the Law of One will be met with acquiescence. If the request is not made, due to the slipping through the net, then there is penetration of this net. Questioner, who makes this request? I am Raw. Your query is unclear. Please restate. Questioner, I didn't quite understand. How does the Confederation stop the Orion chariot from coming through the quarantine? What actions do? I am Raw. There is contact at the level of light form or light body being depending upon the vibratory level of the guardian. These guardians sweep reaches of your Earth's energy fields, attempting to be aware of any entities approaching. An entity which is approaching is hailed in the name of the One Creator. Any entity thus hailed is bathed in love light and will of free will obey the quarantine due to the power of the Law of One. Questioner, what would happen to the entity if he did not obey the quarantine after being hailed? I am raw. To not obey quarantine after being hailed on the level of which we speak would be equivalent to your not stopping upon walking into a solid brick wall. Questioner, what would happen to the entity then, if he did this? What had happened to his chariot? I am raw. The creator is one being. The vibratory level of those able to reach the quarantine boundaries is such that upon seeing the love light net it is impossible to break this law. Therefore, nothing happens. No attempt is made. There is no confrontation. The only beings who are able to penetrate the quarantine are those who discover windows or distortions in the space-time continuum surrounding your planet's energy fields. Through these windows they come. These windows are rare and unpredictable. Questioner, does this account for what we call the UFO flaps, where a large number of UFOs show up like in 1973? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, well then are most of the UFOs which are seen in our skies from the Orion group? I am raw. Many of those seen in your skies are of the Orion group. They send out messages. Some are received by those who are oriented towards service to others. These messages then are altered to be acceptable to those entities while warning of difficulties ahead. This is the most that self-serving entities can do when faced with those whose wish is to serve others. The contacts which the group finds most helpful to their cause are those contacts made with entities whose orientation is towards service to self. There are many thought form entities in your skies which are of a positive nature and are the projections of the Confederation. Other sightings are due to the inadvertent visualization by your people's optical mechanisms of your own government's weaponry. Questioner, which group was it that contacted Henry Purick in Israel, right around 1972? I am raw. We must refrain from answering this query due to the probability that the one you call Henry will read this answer. This would cause distortions in his future. It is necessary that each being use free and complete discernment from within the all-self which is at the heart of the mind-body-spirit complex. Questioner, does that also apply to answering who was contacting the group that I originally was in 1962? I am raw. This query may be answered. The group contacted was the Confederation. Questioner, did they have any of their craft in our area at that time? I am raw. There was no craft. There was a thought form. Questioner, you mentioned the Orion Crusaders. When they do get through the net, give both technical and non-technical information. We know what you mean by technical information, but what type of non-technical information do they give to those they contact? Am I right in assuming that this is all done by telepathic communication? I am raw. This is correct. Through telepathy, the philosophy of the law of one with the distortion of service to self is promulgated. In advanced groups, there are rituals and exercises given, and these have been written down just as the service to others-oriented entities have written down the promulgated philosophy of their teachers. The philosophy concerns the service of manipulating others that they may experience service towards the other self, thus through this experience becoming able to appreciate service to self. These entities thus would become oriented towards service to self and in turn manipulate yet others so that they in turn might experience the service towards the other self. Questioner, would this be the origin of what we call black magic? I am raw. This is correct in one sense, incorrect in another. The Orion group has aided the so-called negatively oriented among your mind-body-spirit complexes. These same entities would be concerning themselves with service to self in any case, and there are many upon your so-called inner planes which are negatively oriented and thus available as inner teachers or guides and so-called possessors of certain souls who seek this distortion of service to self. Questioner, is it possible for an entity here on Earth to be so confused as to call both the Confederation and the Orion group in an alternating way, one, then the other, inaudible back to inaudible? I am raw. It is entirely possible for the untuned channel, as you call that service, to receive both positive and negative communications. If the entity at the base of its confusion is oriented towards service to others, the entity will begin to receive messages of doom. If the entity at the base of the complex of beingness is oriented towards service to self, the Crusaders, who in this case, do not find it necessary to lie, will simply begin to give the philosophy they are here to give. Many of your so-called contacts among your people have been confused and self-destructive because the channels were oriented towards service to others but, in the desire for proof, were open to the lying information of the Crusaders, who then were able to neutralize the effectiveness of the channel. Questioner, are most of these Crusaders fourth density? I am raw. There is a majority of fourth density. That is correct. Questioner, Does an individual in the fourth density normally appear, or are they normally invisible to us? I am raw. The use of the word normal is one which befuddles the meaning of the question. Let us rephrase for clarity. The fourth density is, by choice, not visible to third density. It is possible for fourth density to be visible. However, it is not the choice of the fourth density entity to be visible due to the necessity for concentration upon a rather difficult vibrational complex which is the third density you experience. Questioner, are there any Confederation or Orion individuals living on Earth visible to us and important in our society at this time, walking among us? I am raw. There are no entities of either group walking among you at this time. However, the Crusaders of Orion use two types of entities to do their bidding, shall we say. The first type is a thought form. The second, a kind of robot. Questioner, could you describe the robot? I am raw. The robot may look like any other being. It is a construct. Questioner, is the robot what is normally called Men in Black? I am raw. This is incorrect. Questioner, who are the Men in Black? I am raw. The Men in Black are a thought form type of entity which have some beingness to their makeup. They have certain physical characteristics given them. However, their true vibrational nature is without third density vibrational characteristics and, therefore, they are able to materialize and dematerialize when necessary. Questioner, are all of these Men in Black then used by the Orion Crusaders? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, if one were to visit me and I grabbed him and locked him in a closet, could I keep him, or would he disappear? I am raw. It depends upon which type of entity you grab. You are perhaps able to perceive a construct. The construct might be kept for a brief period, although these constructs also have an ability to disappear. The programming on these constructs, however, makes it more difficult to remotely control them. You would not be able to grapple with a thought form entity of the Men in Black, as you call it, type. Questioner, would this be against the law of one and I would be making a mistake by grabbing these entities? I am raw. There are no mistakes under the law of one. Questioner, what I'm saying is, would I be polarizing more towards self-service or towards service for others when I did this act of locking up the thought form or construct? I am raw. You may consider that question for yourself. We interpret the law of one, but not to the extent of advice. Questioner, thank you. Well, you spoke of wanderers. Who are wanderers? Where do they come from? I am raw. Imagine, if you will, the sands of your shores. As countless as the grains of sand are the sources of intelligent infinity. When a social memory complex has achieved its complete understanding of its desire, it may conclude that its desire is service to others with the distortion towards reaching their hand, figuratively, to any entities who call for aid. These entities, whom you may call the brothers and sisters of sorrow, move towards this calling of sorrow. These entities are from all reaches of the infinite creation and are bound together by the desire to serve in this distortion. Questioner, how many of them are incarnate on Earth now? I am raw. The number is approximate due to an heavy influx of those birthed at this time due to an intensive need to lighten the planetary vibration and thus aid in harvest. The number approaches 65 million. Questioner, are most of these from the fourth density? What density do they come from? I am raw. Few there are of fourth density. The largest number of wanderers, as you call them, are of the sixth density. The desire to serve must be distorted towards a great deal of purity of mind and what you may call foolhardiness or bravery, depending upon your distortion complex judgment. The challenge danger of the wanderer is that it will forget its mission, become karmically involved, and thus be swept into the maelstrom from which it had incarnated to aid the destruction. Questioner, what could one of these entities do to become karmically involved? Could you give us an example? I am raw. An entity which acts in a consciously unloving manner in action with other beings can become karmically involved. Questioner, I just had a thought. Do any of these wanderers have physical ailments in this earth situation? I am raw. Due to the extreme variance between the vibratory distortions of third density and those of the more dense densities, if you will, wanderers have as a general rule some form of handicap, difficulty, or feeling of alienation which is severe. The most common of these difficulties are alienation, the reaction against the planetary vibration by personality disorders, as you would call them, and body complex ailments indicating difficulty in adjustment to the planetary vibrations such as allergies, as you would call them. Questioner, Is there a best way for these entities to heal themselves of their physical ailments? I am Raw. This will be the last complete question of this time-space. The self-healing distortion is affected through realization of the intelligent infinity resting within. This is blocked in some way in those who are not perfectly balanced in bodily complexes. The blockage varies from entity to entity. It requires the conscious awareness of the spiritual nature of reality, if you will, and the corresponding pourings of this reality into the individual mind-body-spirit complex for healing to take place. We will use this instrument as example. The portions of its ailment, as you call this distortion complex, that can be perfected in balance are due primarily to a blockage of the indigo ray or pineal energy center. This center receives the intelligent energy from all sources lawful within the one creation. That is, lawful in this third density distortion or illusion. If there is no blockage, these energies pour or stream down into the mind-body-spirit complex, perfecting moment by moment the individual's body complex. This instrument also experiences some distortion of the green ray energy center, which you may call the heart center. It is overly open due to an intensive desired distortion on the part of this mind-body-spirit complex towards service to others, or as you may call it, universal love. This entity, therefore, spends itself without regard to its reserves of mind-body-spirit complex distortion in regard to what you call strength or energy. This distortion is primarily due to the blockage of the indigo ray. As we have said before, the misapprehension distortion of the instrument responsible for this blockage is the basic orientation towards a belief in unworthiness. The unworthiness distortion blocks the free flow of intelligent energy. The seventh ultraviolet ray is unimpaired, this being not only an energy receptor but a sum total of the vibratory level of the individual. The other energy centers are also quite clear. The solution to healing in this case is action that puts into practice the peaceful understanding and humility distortion that the entity is one with the Creator, therefore perfected and not separate. In each case of what you would call ill health, one or more of these energy centers is blocked. The intelligence of the mind-body-spirit complex needs then to be alerted either by the self as healer or by the catalyst of another healer, as we have said before. Is there a short question before we close this session? Questioner, is it possible for you to tell us if any of the three of us are and have been wanderers? I am Raw. In scanning each of the mind-body-spirit complexes present, we find an already complete assurance of this occurrence and, therefore, find no harm in recapitulating this occurrence. Each of those present are wanderers pursuing a mission, if you will. Questioner, thank you. Is there anything that we can do to make the instrument more comfortable? I am Raw. We ask you to realign the object upon which the symbols sit. It is not a significant distortion for one session only, but you will find upon measuring the entire assemblage that the resting place is 1.4 degrees from the correct alignment, the resting place an additional 1/2 degree, 0.5 degrees away from proper orientation. Do not concern yourselves overly with this in the space-time nexus present, but do not allow these distortions to remain over a long period or the contact will be gradually impaired. I am Raw. I leave you in the love and in the light of the One Infinite Creator. Go forth rejoicing in the power and the peace of the One Creator. Adonai. End of Session 12. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and Registered Trademark and the Social Memory Complex known as Raw. Session 13. I am Raw. I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner, first thing I would like to do is apologize for the stupid questions that I've asked while searching for what we should do. I consider what we are doing a great honor and privilege to be also humble messengers of the Law of One, and at this time believe that the way to prepare this book is to start at the beginning of creation following the evolution of man, and the evolution of man on earth, to the best of my inaudible at all times investigating how the Law of One was used. Inaudible. I think also that I need to finish the book, let the material that we have already carry the end of the book. Inaudible. I would also suggest the title of the book, The Law of One. I'd like to state as the author, Raw. Would you agree to this? I am Raw. Your query is unclear. Would you please state as separate queries each area of agreement? Questioner, first, I'd like to start at the beginning of creation, as far back as we can go, and follow the development of man to the present time. Is this agreeable? I am Raw. This is completely your discernment, understanding, decision. Questioner, secondly, I would like to title the book, The Law of One, by Raw. Is this agreeable? I am Raw. The title of the book is acceptable. The authorship by vibratory sound complex Raw is, In our distortion of understanding, incomplete, we are messengers. Questioner, can you state who then should author the book? I can only request that if your discernment understanding suggests the use of this vibratory sound complex, raw, the phrase "an humble messenger of the law of one" be appended. Questioner, thank you. Can you tell me of the earliest, first known thing in the creation? I am raw. The first known thing in the creation is infinity. The infinity is creation. Questioner, from this infinity then must have come what we experience as creation. What was the next step or the next evolvement? I am raw. Infinity became aware. This was the next step. Questioner, after this, what happened? Awareness led to the focus of infinity into infinite energy. You have called this by various vibrational sound complexes, the most common to your ears being logos or love. The creator is the focusing of infinity as an aware or conscious principle called by us as closely as we can create understanding learning in your language, intelligent infinity. Questioner, can you state the next step? The next step is still at this space-time nexus in your illusion achieving its progression as you may see it in your illusion. The next step is an infinite reaction to the creative principle following the law of one in one of its primal distortions, freedom of will. Thus many, many dimensions, infinite in number, are possible. The energy moves from the intelligent infinity to you first to the outpouring of randomized creative force, this then a creating patterns which in holographic style appears the entire creation no matter which direction or energy is explored. These patterns of energy begin then to regularize their own local, shall we say, rhythms and fields of energy, thus creating dimensions and universes. Questioner, then can you tell me how the galaxy and this planetary system were formed? I am raw. You must imagine a great leap of thought in this query, for at the last query the physical, as you call it, universes were not yet born. The energies moved in increasingly intelligent patterns until the individualization of various energies emanating from the creative principle of intelligent infinity became such as to be co-creators. Thus the so-called physical matter began. The concept of light is instrumental in grasping this great leap of thought as this vibrational distortion of infinity is the building block of that which is known as matter. The light being intelligent and full of energy, thus being the first distortion of intelligent infinity which was called by the creative principle. This light of love was made to have in its occurrences of being certain characteristics, among them the infinite whole paradoxically described by the straight line, as you would call it. This paradox is responsible for the shape of the various physical illusion entities you call solar systems, galaxies, and planets, all revolving and tending towards the lenticular. Questioner, I think I made an error in asking that question, getting ahead of the process that you were describing. Would it be helpful to fill in that great leap that I mistakenly made? I am raw. I attempted to bridge the gap. However, you may question me in any manner you deem appropriate. Questioner, could you tell me, taking the question previous to the one that I asked about galaxy and planets, would you tell me the next step that occurred after that step? I am raw. The steps, as you call them, are, at the point of question, simultaneous and infinite. Questioner, could you tell me how intelligent infinity became, shall we say, I'm having difficulty with some of the language, how intelligent infinity became individualized from itself? I am raw. This is an appropriate question. The intelligent infinity discerned a concept. This concept was discerned due to freedom of will of awareness. This concept was finity. This was the first and primal paradox or distortion of the law of one. Thus the one intelligent infinity invested itself in an exploration of manyness. Due to the infinite possibilities of intelligent infinity, there is no ending to manyness. The exploration, thus, is free to continue infinitely in an eternal present. Questioner, was the galaxy that we are in created by the infinite intelligence or was it created by a portion of the individualized infinite intelligence? I am raw. The galaxy and all other things of material of which you are aware are products of individualized portions of intelligent infinity. As each exploration began, it, in turn, found its focus and became co-creator. Using intelligent infinity, each portion created a universe and allowing the rhythms of free choice to flow, playing with the infinite spectrum of possibilities. Each individualized portion channeled the love light into what you might call intelligent energy, thus creating the so-called natural laws of any particular universe. Each universe, in turn, individualized to a focus becoming, in turn, co-creator and allowing further diversity, thus creating further intelligent energies regularizing or causing natural laws to appear in the vibrational patterns of what you would call a solar system. Thus, each solar system has its own, shall we say, local coordinate system of illusory natural laws. It shall be understood that any portion, no matter how small, of any density or illusory pattern contains, as in an holographic picture, the one creator which is infinity. Thus all begins and ends in mystery. Questioner, could you tell me how the individualized portion of intelligent infinity created our galaxy, inaudible that the same portion created our planetary system and, if so, how this came about? I am Raw. We may have misperceived your query. We were under the distortion impression that we had responded to this particular query. Would you restate the query? Questioner, primarily, then, how the, shall we say, the planetary system that we are in now evolved, was it all created at once or was there first our sun created and this, inaudible was created? I am Raw. The process is from the larger, in your illusion, to the smaller. Thus the co-creator, individualizing the galaxy, created energy patterns which then focused in multitudinous focuses of further conscious awareness of intelligent infinity. Thus, the solar system of which you experience inhabitation is of its own patterns, rhythms, and so-called natural laws which are unique to itself. However, the progression is from the galaxy spiraling energy to the solar spiraling energy, to the planetary spiraling energy, to the experiential circumstances of spiraling energy which begin the first density of awareness or consciousness of planetary entities. Questioner, could you tell me about this first density of planetary entities? I am Raw. Each step recapitulates intelligent infinity in its discovery of awareness. In a planetary environment, all begins in what you would call chaos, energy undirected and random in its infinity. Slowly, in your terms of understanding, there forms a focus of self-awareness. Thus the logos moves. Light comes to form the darkness, according to the co-creator's patterns and vibratory rhythms, so constructing a certain type of experience. This begins with first density, which is the density of consciousness, the mineral and water life upon the planet learning from fire and wind the awareness of being. This is the first density. Questioner, does this first density then progress to greater awareness? The spiraling energy, which is the characteristic of what you call light, moves in straight line spiral, thus giving spirals an inevitable vector upwards to a more comprehensive beingness with regards to intelligent infinity. Thus, first dimensional beingness strives towards the second density, lessons of a type of awareness which includes growth rather than dissolution or random change. Questioner, could you define what you mean by growth? I am Raw. Picture, if you will, the difference between first vibrational mineral or water life and the lower second density beings which begin to move about within and upon its being. This movement is the characteristic of second density, the striving towards light and growth. Questioner, by striving toward light, what do you mean? I am Raw. A very simplistic example of second density growth striving towards light is that of the leaf striving towards the source of light. Questioner, is there any physical difference between first and second density? For instance, if I could see a second density planet and a first density planet side by side, in my present condition, could I see both of them? Would they be both visible? I am Raw. This is correct. All of the octave of your densities would be clearly visible, were not the fourth through the seventh freely choosing not to be visible. Questioner, then how does the second density progress to the third? I am Raw. The second density strives towards the third density, which is the density of self-consciousness or self-awareness. The striving takes place through the higher second density forms who are invested by third density beings with an identity to the extent that they become self-aware mind-body complexes, thus becoming mind-body-spirit complexes and entering third density, the first density of consciousness of spirit. Questioner, what is the density level of our planet Earth at this time? I am Raw. The sphere upon which you dwell is third density in its beingness of mind-body-spirit complexes. It is now in a space-time continuum, fourth density. This is causing a somewhat difficult harvest. Questioner, how does a third density planet become a fourth density? I am Raw. This will be the last full question. The fourth density is, as we have said, a has regularized in its approach as the striking of a clock upon the hour. The space-time of your solar system has enabled this planetary sphere to spiral into space-time of a different vibrational configuration. This causes the planetary sphere to be able to be molded by these new distortions. However, the thought forms of your people during this transition period are such that the mind-body-spirit complexes of both individual and societies are scattered throughout the spectrum instead of becoming able to grasp the needle, shall we say, and point the compass in one direction. Thus, the entry into the vibration of love, sometimes called by your people the vibration of understanding, is not effective with the present societal complex. Thus, the harvest shall be such that many will repeat the third density cycle. The energies of your wanderers, your teachers, and your adepts at this time are all bent upon increasing the harvest. However, there are few to harvest. Questioner, I would like to apologize for asking sometimes wrong or inappropriate questions. It's difficult sometimes to ask precisely the right question. I don't wish to go over any ground that we've already covered. I notice this period is slightly shorter than previous periods. Is there a reason for this? I am raw. This instrument's vital energy is somewhat low. Questioner, I am assuming from this that it would be a good idea not to have another session today. Is this correct? I am raw. It is well to have a session later if it is acceptable that we monitor this instrument and cease using it when it becomes low in the material which we take from it. We do not wish to deplete this instrument. Questioner, this is always acceptable in any session. I will ask my final question. Is there anything that we can do to make the instrument more comfortable or facilitate these communications? I am raw. It is well. Each is most conscientious. Continue in the same. Is there any other short query? Questioner, Tom Flaherty will be here this evening and will be helping in the evening session. Is this all right? I am raw. This is correct. I am raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator, Adonai. End of session 13. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 14. I am RAW. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. We communicate now. Questioner, going back over this morning's work, inaudible. You said the second density strives towards the third density, which is the density of self-consciousness or self-awareness. The striving takes place through higher second density forms invested by third density beings. Could you explain what you mean by this? I am raw. Much as you would put on a vestment, so do your third density beings invest or clothe some second density beings with self-awareness. This is often done through the opportunity of what you call pets. It has also been done by various other means of investiture. These include many so-called religious practice complexes which personify and send love to various natural second density beings in their group form. Questioner, when this earth was second density, how did the second density beings on this earth become so invested? There was not this type of investment as spoken, but the simple third density investment, which is the line of spiraling light calling distortion upward from density to density. The process takes longer when there is no investment made by incarnate third density beings. Questioner, then what was the second density form? What did it look like that became Earthman in the third density? What did he look like in the second density? I am raw. The difference between second and third density bodily forms would in many cases have been more like one to the other. In the case of your planetary sphere, the process was interrupted by those who incarnated here from the planetary sphere you call Mars. They were adjusted by genetic changing and, therefore, there was some difference which was of a very noticeable variety rather than the gradual raising of the bipedal forms upon your second density level to third density level. This has nothing to do with the so-called placement of the soul. This has only to do with the circumstances of the influx of those from that culture. Questioner, I understand from previous material that this occurred 75,000 years ago. Then it was our third density process of evolution began. Can you tell me the history, hitting only the points of development, shall I say, that occurred within this 75,000 years, any particular times or points where the attempts were made to increase the development of this third density? I am raw. The first attempt to aid your peoples was at the time 75,000. This attempt 75,000 of your years ago has been previously described by us. The next attempt was approximately 58,000 of your years ago, continuing for a long period in your measurement, With those of Mu, as you call this race or mind-body-spirit social complex. The next attempt was long in coming and occurred approximately 13,000 of your years ago, when some intelligent information was offered to those of Atlantis, this being of the same type of healing and crystal working of which we have spoken previously. The next attempt was 11,000 of your years ago. These are approximations, as we are not totally able to process your space-time continuum measurement system. This was in what you call Egypt, and of this we have also spoken. The same beings which came with us returned approximately 3,500 years later in order to attempt to aid the South American mind-body-spirit social complex once again. However, the pyramids of those so-called cities were not to be used in the appropriate fashion. Therefore, this was not pursued further. There was a landing approximately 3,000 of your years ago, also in your South America, as you call it. There were a few attempts to aid your peoples approximately 2,300 years ago, this in the area of Egypt. The remaining part of the cycle, we have never been gone from your fifth dimension and have been working in this last minor cycle to prepare for harvest. Questioner, was the Egyptian visit of 11,000 years ago the only one where you actually walked the earth? I am raw. I understand your question distorted in the direction of selves rather than other selves. We of the vibratory sound complex, raw, have walked among you only at that time. Questioner, I understood you to say in an earlier session that pyramids were built to ring the earth. How many pyramids were built? I am raw. There are 6 balancing pyramids and 52 others built for additional healing and initiatory work among your mind, body, spirit, social complexes. Questioner, what is a balancing pyramid? I am raw. Imagine, if you will, the many force fields of the earth in their geometrically precise web. Energies stream into the earth planes, as you would call them, from magnetically determined points. Due to growing thought form distortions in understanding of the law of one, the planet itself was seen to have the potential for imbalance. The balancing pyramidal structures were charged with crystals which drew the appropriate balance from the energy forces streaming into the various geometrical centers of electromagnetic energy which surround and shape the planetary sphere. Questioner, let me make a synopsis and you tell me if I am correct. All of these visits for the last 75,000 years were for the purpose of giving to the people of Earth an understanding of the law of one, and this way allow them to progress upward through the fourth, fifth, sixth densities. This was to be a service to Earth. The pyramids were used also in giving the law of one in their own way. The balancing pyramids, I'm not quite sure of. Am I right so far? I am raw. You are correct to the limits of the precision allowed by language. Questioner, did the balancing pyramid cause the earth from changing its axis? I am raw. This query is not clear. Please restate. Questioner, does the balancing refer to balancing of the individual who is initiated in the pyramid, or does it refer to the physical balancing of the earth on its axis in space? I am raw. The balancing pyramidal structures could be and were used for individual initiation. However, the use of these pyramids was also designed for the balancing of the planetary energy web. The other pyramids are not placed properly for earth healing, but for healing of mind-body-spirit complexes. It came to our attention that your density was distorted towards what is called by our distortion understanding of third density, a premature aging process. We were attempting to aid in giving the mind-body-spirit complexes of third density on your planetary sphere more of a time-space continuum and one incarnation pattern in order to have a fuller opportunity to learn, teach the laws or ways of the primal distortion of the law of one, which is love. Questioner, I will make this statement. You can tell me if I am correct. The way I understand it, the balancing pyramids were to do what we call increase the lifespan of entities here so that they would gain more wisdom of the law of one while in the physical at one time. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. However, the pyramids not called by us by the vibrational sound complex, balancing pyramids, were more numerous and were used exclusively for the above purpose and the teach learning of healers to charge and enable these processes. Questioner, George Van Tassel built a machine in our western desert called an integratron. Will this machine work for that purpose, of increasing the lifespan? I am raw. The machine is incomplete and will not function for the above mentioned purpose. Questioner, who gave George the information on how to build it? I am raw. There were two contacts which gave the entity with vibratory sound complex, George, this information. One was of the Confederation, the second was of the Orion Group. The Confederation was caused to find the distortion towards non-contact due to the alteration of the vibrational mind complex patterns of the one called George. Thus, the Orion Group used this instrument. However, this instrument, though confused, was a mind-body-spirit complex devoted at the heart to service to others, so the, shall we say, worst that could be done was to discredit this source. Questioner, would there be any value to the people of this planet now, at this time, to complete this machine? I am raw. The harvest is now. There is not at this time any reason to include efforts along these distortions towards longevity, but rather to encourage distortions towards seeking the heart of self, for this which resides clearly in the violet ray energy field will determine the harvesting of each mind-body-spirit complex. Questioner, going back to the start of this 75,000-year period, there was the harvesting 25,000 years after the start, which would make it 50,000 years ago, I would assume. Can you tell me how many were harvested from our planet at that time? I am raw. The harvest was none. Questioner, there was no harvest? What about 25,000 years ago? Was there a harvest then? I am raw. A harvesting began taking place in the latter portion, as you measure time-space, of the second cycle, with individuals finding the gateway to intelligent infinity. The harvest at that time, though extremely small, were those entities of extreme distortion towards service to the entities which now were to repeat the major cycle. These entities, therefore, remained in third density, although they could, at any moment present nexus, leave this density through use of intelligent infinity. Questioner, then the harvest 25,000 years ago, the entities who could have been harvested to the fourth density remained here in service to this planetary population. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. Thus, there was no harvest, but there were harvestable entities who shall choose the manner of their entrance into fourth dimension. Questioner, then for the last 2,300 years you have been actively working to create as large a harvest as possible at the end of the total 75,000-year cycle. Can you state with respect to the law of one why you do this, just as a statement of your reasons for this? I am raw. I speak for the social memory complex termed raw. We came among you to aid you. Our efforts in service were perverted. Our desire then is to eliminate as far as possible the distortions caused by those misreading our information and guidance. The general cause of service such as the Confederation offers is that of the primal distortion of the law of one, which is service. The one being of the creation is like unto a body. If you will accept this third density analogy, would we ignore a pain in the leg, a bruise upon the skin, a cut which is festering? No. There is no ignoring a call. We, the entities of sorrow, choose as our service the attempt to heal the sorrow which we are calling analogous to the pains of a physical body complex distortion. Questioner, at what density level is raw? I am raw. I am sixth density with a strong seeking towards seventh density. The harvest for us will be in only approximately 2.5 million of your years, and it is our desire to be ready for harvest as it approaches in our space-time continuum. Questioner, and you ready yourselves for harvest through the best service you can provide. Is this correct? This is correct. We offer the law of one, the solving of paradoxes, the balancing of love light and light love. Questioner, how long is one of your cycles? I am raw. One of our cycles computes to 75 million of your years. Questioner, 75 million? That is correct. Questioner, in your service in giving the law of one, do you work with any planets other than the Earth at this time, or just Earth? I am raw. We work only with this planetary sphere at this time. Questioner, you stated that you were called by 352,000 Earth entities. Does this mean that this number is the number who will understand and accept the law of one? Am I correct? I am raw. We cannot estimate the correctness of your statement, for those who call are not in every case able to understand the answer to their calling. Moreover, those who were not calling previously may, with great trauma, discover the answers to the call nearly simultaneously with their late call. There is no time-space in call. Therefore, we cannot estimate the number of your mind-body-spirit complexes which will, in your space-time continuum distortion, hear and understand. Questioner, how do you perform your normal service? How have you normally given the law of one over the last 2,300 years? How have you normally given this to Earth people? I am raw. We have used channels such as this one, but in most cases the channels feel inspired by dreams and visions without being aware, consciously, of our identity or existence. This particular group has been accentuatedly trained to recognize such contact. This makes this group able to be aware of a focal or vibrational source of information. Questioner, when you contact the entities in their dreams and otherwise, these entities, I assume, have to be first seeking in the direction of the law of one. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. For example, the entities of the nation of Egypt were in a state of pantheism, as you may call the distortion towards separate worship of various portions of the Creator. We were able to contact one whose orientation was towards the One. Questioner, the trauma, I'll just call it that, I assume this will, as the cycle ends, have some inconvenience, inaudible. There will be some entities who start seeking or get catalyzed, you might say, into seeking because of the trauma, and will then maybe hear your words through possibly telepathy or written material such as we will publish as this book. I am raw. You are correct except in understanding that the inconveniences have begun. Questioner, can you tell me who was responsible for transmitting the book OAHSPE? I am raw. This was transmitted by one of Confederation Social Memory Complex Status whose idea, as offered to the Council, was to use some of the known physical history of the so-called religions or religious distortions of your cycle in order to veil and partially unveil aspects or primal distortions of the law of one. All names can be taken to be created for their vibrational characteristics. The information buried within has to do with a deeper understanding of love and light, and the attempts of infinite intelligence through many messengers to teach learn those entities of your sphere. Questioner, have there been any other books that you can name that are available for this purpose that have been given by the Confederation? I am raw. We cannot share this information, for it would distort your discernment patterns in your future. You may ask about a particular volume. Questioner, the Urantia book, which I haven't read. Who gave that? I am raw. This was given by a series of discarnate entities of your own earth planes, the so-called inner planes. This material is not passed by the Council. Questioner, the Edgar Case material. Who spoke through Edgar Case? I am raw. No entity spoke through Edgar Case. Questioner, where did the information come from that Edgar Case channeled? I am raw. We have explained before that the intelligent infinity is brought into intelligent energy from eighth density or the octave. The one vibratory sound complex called Edgar used this gateway to view the present, which is not the continuum you experience but the potential social memory complex of this planetary sphere. The term your peoples have used for this is the Akashic Record or the Hall of Records. This is the last question which you may now ask. Questioner, is there anything that we can do to make the instrument more comfortable or help during the transmission? I am raw. We only reiterate the importance of alignment. This instrument is placed 0.2 degrees away from the direction of the resting place, which is correct. This may be eyed, shall we say, by sight and the instrument reminded. You are being conscientious. Is there any brief question we may answer before this session is closed? Questioner, can you tell me if we are accomplishing our effort reasonably well? I am raw. The law is one. There are no mistakes. I am raw. I leave this instrument in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, therefore, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the One Creator, Adonai. End of Session 14. The Law of One. Unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 15. I am RAW. I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. I communicate now. Questioner, I would like to apologize for my past and any future stupid questions due to the fact that I am searching for the proper entry into investigating the Law of One. We will be eliminating the stupid ones from the book. I would like to ask if the use of the instrument is a function of the time we use the instrument or the amount of information or the number of words the instrument gives. In other words, do I have to hurry and ask the questions, or can I take my time to ask the questions? I am raw. There are two portions to your query. Firstly, this instrument's reserve of vital energy, which is a product of body, mind, and spirit distortions in the various complexes, is the key to the length of time which we may expend using this instrument. We searched your group when we contacted you, for each in your group possesses significantly more vital energy of the body complex. However, this instrument was tuned most appropriately by the mind-body-spirit complex distortions of its beingness in this illusion. Therefore, we remained with this instrument. Secondly, we communicate at a set rate which is dependent upon our careful manipulation of this instrument. We cannot be more, as you would say, quick. Therefore, You may ask questions speedily, but the answers we have to offer are at a set pace given. Questioner, this isn't exactly what I meant. If it takes me, say, 45 minutes to ask my questions, does that give the instrument only 15 minutes to answer rather than an hour? Or would we run over an hour and the instrument could answer for more? I am raw. The energy required for this contact is entered into this instrument by a function of time. Therefore, the time is the factor, as we understand your query. Questioner, then I should ask my questions rapidly so that I do not reduce the time. Is this correct? I am raw. You shall do as you deem fit. However, we may suggest that to obtain the answers you require may mean that you invest some of what you experience as time. Although you lose the answer time, you gain thereby in the specificity of the answer, as many times in the past we have needed clarification of hastily phrased questions. Questioner, thank you. The first question is, why does rapid aging occur on this planet? I am raw. Rapid aging occurs upon this third density planet due to an ongoing imbalance of receptor web complex in the etheric portion of the energy field of this planet. The thought form distortions of your peoples have caused the energy streamings to enter the planetary magnetic atmosphere, if you would so term this web of energy patterns, in such a way that the proper streamings are not correctly imbued with balanced vibratory light love from the, shall we say, cosmic level of this octave of existence. Questioner, do I assume correctly in assuming that one of your attempts in service to this planet was to help the population of this planet more fully understand and practice the law of one so that this aging, rapid aging could be changed to normal aging? I am raw. You assume correctly to a great degree. Questioner, then it would be very beneficial for the people of this planet in practicing the law of one to learn ways of service. Am I correct? I am raw. You are correct. If you will observe those oriented through a lifetime experiential distortion complex from near the beginning of that experience, you will observe a relatively youthful, as you would call it, appearance. Questioner, what is the greatest service that our population on this planet could perform individually? I am raw. There is but one service. The law is one. The offering of self to Creator is the greatest service, the unity, the fountainhead. The entity who seeks the one Creator is with infinite intelligence. From this seeking, from this offering, a great multiplicity of opportunities will evolve depending upon the mind-body-spirit complex's distortions with regard to the various illusory aspects or energy centers of the various complexes of your illusion. Thus, some become healers, some workers, some teachers, and so forth. Questioner, if an entity were perfectly balanced on this planet with respect to the law of one, would he undergo the aging process? I am raw. A perfectly balanced entity would become tired rather than visibly aged. The lessons being learned, the entity would depart. However, this is appropriate and is a form of aging which your peoples do not experience. The understanding comes slowly, the body complex decomposing more rapidly. Questioner, can you tell me a little bit about the definition of the word balancing as we are using it? I am raw. Picture, if you will, the one infinite. You have no picture. Thus, the process begins. Love, creating light, becoming love light, streams into the planetary sphere according to the electromagnetic web of points or nexi of entrance. These streamings are then available to the individual who, like the planet, is a web of electromagnetic energy fields with points or nexi of entrance. In a balanced individual, each energy center is balanced and functioning brightly and fully. The blockages of your planetary sphere cause some distortion of intelligent energy. The blockages of the mind-body-spirit complex further distort or unbalance this energy. There is one energy. It may be understood as love light or light love or intelligent energy. Questioner, am I correct in assuming that one of the blockages of a mind-body-spirit complex might be due to an imbalance of, shall we say, ego, and this could be balanced using, say, a worthiness-unworthiness balance? I am raw. This is incorrect. Questioner, can you tell me how you balance the ego? I am raw. We cannot work with this concept as it is misapplied and understanding cannot come from it. Questioner, how does an individual go about balancing himself? What is the first step? I am raw. The steps are only one. That is, an understanding of the energy centers which make up the mind-body-spirit complex. This understanding may be briefly summarized as follows. The first balancing is of the Markov, or Earth, vibratory energy complex, called the Red Ray complex. An understanding and acceptance of this energy is fundamental. The next energy complex, which may be blocked, is the emotional, or personal complex, also known as the Orange Ray Complex. This blockage will often demonstrate itself as personal eccentricities or distortions with regard to self-conscious understanding or acceptance of self. The third blockage resembles most closely that which you have called ego. It is the yellow ray or solar plexus center. Blockages in this center will often manifest as distortions towards power manipulation and other social behaviors concerning those close and those associated with a mind-body-spirit complex. Those with blockages in these first three energy centers, or nexi, will have continuing difficulties in ability to further their seeking of the law of one. The center of heart, or green ray, is the center from which third density beings may springboard, shall we say, towards infinite intelligence. Blockages in this area may manifest as difficulties in expressing what you may call universal love or compassion. The blue ray center of energy streaming is the center which, for the first time, is outgoing as well as inpouring. Those blocked in this area may have difficulty in grasping the spirit-mind complexes of its own entity and further difficulty in expressing such understandings of self. Entities blocked in this area may have difficulties in accepting communication from other mind-body-spirit complexes. The next center is the pineal or indigo ray center. Those blocked in this center may experience a lessening of the influx of intelligent energy due to manifestations which appears unworthiness. This is that of which you spoke. As you can see, this is but one of many distortions due to the several points of energy and flux into the mind-body-spirit complex. The indigo ray balancing is quite central to the type of work which revolves about the spirit complex, which is its influx then into the transformation or transmutation of third density to fourth density, it being the energy center receiving the least distorted outpourings of love light from intelligent energy and having also the potential for the key to the gateway of intelligent infinity. The remaining center of energy and flux is simply the total expression of the entity's vibratory complex of mind, body, and spirit. It is as it will be. Balanced or imbalanced has no meaning at this energy level, for it gives and takes in its own balance. Whatever the distortion may be, it cannot be manipulated as can the others and, therefore, has no particular importance in viewing the balancing of an entity. Questioner, you previously gave us some information about what we should do in balancing. Is there any information that we can publish now about any particular exercises or methods of balancing these centers? I am raw. The exercises given for publication seen in comparison with the material now given are in total a good beginning. It is important to allow each seeker to enlighten itself rather than for any messenger to attempt in language to teach learn for the entity, thus being teach learner and learn teacher. This is not in balance with your third density. We learn from you. We teach to you. Thus, we teach learn. If we learn for you, this would cause imbalance in the direction of the distortion of free will. There are other items of information allowable. However, you have not yet reached these items in your lines of questioning and it is our belief-feeling complex that the questioner shall shape this material in such a way that your mind-body-spirit complexes shall have entry to it. Thus we answer your queries as they arise in your mind complex. Questioner, yesterday you stated the harvest is now. There is not at this time any reason to include efforts upon these distortions toward longevity, but rather to encourage distortions towards the heart of self. For this which resides clearly in the violet ray energy field will determine the harvest of each mind-body-spirit complex. Could you tell us how to seek or the best way to seek the heart of self? I am raw. We have given you this information in several wordings. However, we can only say the material for your understanding is the self, the mind-body-spirit complex. You have been given information upon healing, as you call this distortion. This information may be seen in a more general context as ways to understand a self. The understanding, experiencing, accepting, and merging of self with self and with other self, and finally with the Creator, is the path to the heart of self. In each infinitesimal part of yourself resides the One in all of its power. Therefore, we can only encourage these lines of contemplation, always stating the prerequisite of meditation, contemplation, or prayer as a means of subjectively objectively using or combining various understandings to enhance the seeking process. Without such a method of reversing the analytical process, one could not integrate into unity the many understandings gained in such seeking. Questioner, I don't mean to ask the same question twice, but there are some areas I consider so important that greater understanding may be obtained by possible restatement. In other words, I thank you very much for your patience. Yesterday, you also mentioned that when there was no harvest at the end of the last 25,000 year period, There were harvestable entities who shall choose the manner of their entrance into the fourth density. Can you tell me what you mean by how they will choose the manner of their entrance into the fourth density? I am Ra, these shepherds, or, as some have called them, the elder race, shall choose the time-space of their leaving. They are unlikely to leave until their other selves are harvestable also. Questioner, what do you mean by their other selves being harvestable? I am Ra. The other selves with whom these beings are concerned are those which did not attain harvest during the second major cycle. Questioner, could you tell me just a small amount of the history of what you call the elder race? I am Ra. The question is unclear. Please restate. Questioner, I ask this question because I've heard about the elder race before in a book, Road in the Sky, by George Hunt Williamson, and I was wondering if this elder race was the same that he talked about. I am Ra. The question now resolves itself, for we have spoken previously of the manner of decision-making which caused these entities to remain here upon the closing of the second major cycle of your current master cycle. There are some distortions in the descriptions of the one known as Michelle. However, these distortions have primarily to do with the fact that these entities are not a social memory complex, but rather a group of mind-body-spirit complexes dedicated to service. These entities work together, but are not completely unified. Thus, they do not completely see each the other's thoughts, feelings, and motives. However, their desire to serve is the fourth-dimensional type of desire, thus melding them into what you may call a brotherhood. Questioner, why do you call them the elder race? I am Ra. We called them thusly to acquaint you, the questioner, with their identity as is understood by your mind complex distortion. Questioner, are there any wanderers with these elder race, or not? I am Ra. These are planetary entities harvested wanderers only in the sense that they chose, in fourth density love, to immediately reincarnate in third density rather than proceeding towards fourth density. This causes them to be wanderers of a type, wanderers who have never left the earth plane because of their free will rather than because of their vibrational level. Questioner, well, in yesterday's material you stated we offer the law of one, the solving of paradoxes. You also mentioned earlier that the first paradox, or the first distortion I meant, was the distortion of free will. Could you tell me if there's a sequence? Is there a first, second, third, fourth distortion of the law of one? I am Ra. Only up to a very short point. After this point, the manyness of distortions are equal one to another. The first distortion, free will, finds focus. This is the second distortion known to you as Logos, the creative principle or love. This intelligent energy thus creates a distortion known as light. From these three distortions come many, many hierarchies of distortions, each having its own paradoxes to be synthesized, no one being more important than another. Questioner, you also said that you offered the law of one, which is the balancing of love light and light love. Is there any difference between love light and light love? I am Ra. This will be the final question of this time space. There is the same difference between love light and light love as there is between teach learning and learn teaching. Love light is the enabler, the power, the energy giver. Light love is the manifestation which occurs when light has been impressed with love. Questioner, is there anything that we can do to make the instrument more comfortable? And can we have another session today? I am Ra. This instrument requires a certain amount of manipulation of the physical or body complex due to a stiffness. Other than this, all is well, the energy is being balanced. There is a slight distortion in the mental energy of this instrument due to concern for a loved one, as you call it. This is only slightly lowering the vital energies of the instrument. Given a manipulation, this instrument will be well for another working. Questioner, by manipulation, do you mean she should go for a walk or we should rub her back? I am Ra. We meant the latter. The understanding must be added that this manipulation be done by one in harmony with the entity. Are there any short queries before we leave this instrument? Questioner, is it possible for you to tell us anything about what, since we are wanderers, anything about our previous density, which density we came from? I scan each and find it acceptable to share this information. The wanderers in this working are of two densities, one the density of five, that is, of light, one the density of love light, or unity. To express the identity of which came from which density, we observe to be an infringement upon the free will of each. Therefore, we state simply the two densities, both of which are harmoniously oriented towards work together. I am Ra. I leave you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. Go forth, then, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the One Infinite Creator, Adonai, and of Session 15, the Law of One, unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark, and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 16, I am RAW, I greet you in the love and the light of the Infinite Creator. We communicate now. Questioner, as I ask questions, there will unfortunately be inaudible, I think, the direction I wish to go investigating the Law of One. However, I have ideas in mind of some questions, inaudible. They may be stupid questions, I don't know, but inaudible, trying to construct a complete, unbiased book about the Law of One, one which itself takes into account the Law of One. I hope that you, inaudible ridiculous. I would like to ask, considering the free will distortion of the Law of One, how can the Guardians quarantine the Earth? Is this quarantine within the free will distortion? I am RAW. The Guardians guard the free will distortion of the mind-body-spirit complexes of third density on this planetary sphere. The events which require activation of quarantine were interfering with the free will distortion of mind-body-spirit complexes. Questioner, I may be wrong, but it seems to me that it would be the free will of, say, the Orion Group, to interfere. How is this balanced against the other concept you just gave? I am RAW. The balancing is from dimension to dimension. The attempts of the so-called crusaders to interfere with free will are acceptable upon the dimension of their understanding. However, the mind-body-spirit complexes of this dimension you call third form, a dimension of free will which is not able to, shall we say, recognize in full the distortions towards manipulation. Thus, in order to balance the dimensional variances in vibration, a quarantine was set up, this being a balancing situation whereby the free will of the Orion group is not stopped but given a challenge. Meanwhile, the third density group is not hindered from free choice. Questioner, could these windows that occur let the Orion group come through once in a while? Does this have anything to do with this free will distortion? I am RAW. This is correct. Questioner, could you tell me how that works? I am RAW. The closest analogy would be a random number generator within certain limits. Questioner, what is the source of this random number generator? Is it created by the Guardians to balance their guarding, or is it a source other than the Guardians? I am RAW. All sources are one. However, we understand your query. The window phenomenon is another self-phenomenon from the Guardians. It operates from the dimensions beyond space-time in what you may call the area of intelligent energy. Like your cycles, such balancing, such rhythms are as a clock striking. In the case of the windows, no entities have the clock. Therefore, it seems random. It is not random in the dimension which produces this balance. That is why we stated the analogy was within certain limits. Questioner, then this window balancing prevents the Guardians from reducing their positive polarization by totally eliminating the Orion contact through shielding. Is this correct? I am RAW. This is partially correct. In effect, the balancing allows an equal amount of positive and negative influx, this balanced by the mind-body-spirit distortions of the social complex. Thus on your particular planetary sphere, less negative, as you would call it, information or stimulus is necessary than positive due to the somewhat negative orientation of your social complex distortion. Questioner, in this way, total free will is balanced so that the individual may have an equal opportunity to choose service to others or service to self. Is this correct? I am RAW. This is correct. Questioner, this is a profound revelation, I believe, in the law of free will. Thank you. This is a minor question further to make an example of this principle, but if the Confederation landed on Earth, they would be taken as gods, breaking the law of free will and thus reducing their polarization towards service to all. I assume that the same thing would happen if the Orion group landed. How would this affect their polarization towards service to self if they were able to land and became known as gods? I am RAW. In the event of mass landing of the Orion group, the effect of polarization would be strongly towards an increase in the service to self, precisely the opposite of the former opportunity which you mentioned. Questioner, if the Orion group was able to land, would this increase their polarization? What I am trying to get at is it better for them to work behind the scenes and get recruits, shall we say, from our planet, the person on our planet going towards service to self strictly on his own using his free will, or is it just as good for the Orion group to land upon our planet and demonstrate remarkable powers and get people like that? I am RAW. The first instance is, in the long run, shall we put it, more salubrious for the Orion group in that it does not infringe upon the law of one by landing and, thus, does its work through those of this planet. In the second circumstance, A mass landing would create a loss of polarization due to the infringement upon the free will of the planet. However, it would be a gamble. If the planet then were conquered and became part of the Empire, the free will would then be re-established. This is restrained in action due to the desire of the Orion group to progress towards the One Creator. This desire to progress inhibits the group from breaking the law of confusion. Questioner, you mention the word Empire in relation to the Orion group. I have thought for some time that the movie Star Wars was somehow an allegory, in part, for what is actually happening. Is this correct? I am wrong. This is correct in the same way that a simple children's story is an allegory for physical, philosophical, social complex distortion understanding. Questioner, is there a harvest of entities oriented towards service to self like there is a harvest here of entities oriented towards service to others? I am raw. There is one harvest. Those able to enter fourth density through vibrational complex levels may choose the manner of their further seeking of the One Creator. Questioner, then as we enter the fourth density there will be a split, shall we say, and part of the individuals who go into the fourth density will go to planets or places where there is service to others and the other part will go into places where there is service to self. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, well, the Confederation established its quarantine I understand 75,000 years ago. Has the Orion group been attempting to contact any part of this planet prior to that or did they? How long have they been attempting, inaudible contacting this planet? I am raw. Approximately 45,000 years ago an attempt was made. It was not successful. Approximately 2600 years ago the group sent an entity of social memory complex to this planetary sphere. This effort met with some success but was in the space-time continuum lessened in impact. Since approximately 2300 years ago in your measurement this group has constantly been working upon the harvest just as the Confederation Raw corrected these dates in session 17. They should be 3600 and 3300 years ago, respectively. Questioner, can you name the entity that they sent here 2600 years ago 2600 years ago? The correct time frame is 3600 years. See Raw's statement opening session 17. I am Raw. This entity named by your peoples, Yahweh. Questioner, can you tell me the origin of the Ten Commandments? I am Raw. The origin of these commandments follows the law of negative entities impressing information upon positively oriented mind-body-spirit complexes. The information attempted to copy or ape positivity while retaining negative characteristics. Questioner, was this done by the Orion group? I am Raw. This is correct. Questioner, what was their purpose in doing this? I am Raw. The purpose of the Orion group, as mentioned before, is conquest and enslavement. This is done by finding and establishing an elite and causing others to serve the elite through various devices such as the laws you mentioned and others given by this entity. Questioner, was the recipient of the laws of the Ten Commandments positively or negatively oriented? The recipient was one of extreme positivity, thus accounting for some of the pseudo-positive characteristics of the information received. As with contacts which are not successful, this entity, vibratory complex, Moish, did not remain a credible influence among those who had first heard the philosophy of one and this entity was removed from this third density vibratory level in a lessened or saddened state, having lost what you may call the honor and faith with which he had begun the conceptualization of the law of one and the freeing of those who were of his tribes, as they were called at that time space. Questioner, if this entity was positively oriented, how was the Orion group able to contact him? I am Raw. This was an intensive, shall we say, battleground between positively oriented forces of Confederation origin and negatively oriented sources. The one called Moish was opening to impression and received the law of one in its most simple form. However, the information became negatively oriented due to his people's pressure to do specific physical things in the third density planes. This left the entity open for the type of information and philosophy of a self-service nature. Questioner, it would be unlike an entity fully aware of the knowledge of the law of one to ever say thou shalt not. Is this correct? I am Raw. This is correct. Questioner, can you give me some kind of history of your social memory complex and how you became aware of the law of one? I am Raw. The path of our learning is graven in the present moment. There is no history, as we understand your concept. Picture, if you will, a circle of being. We know the Alpha and Omega as infinite intelligence. The circle never ceases. It is present. The densities we have traversed at various points in the circle correspond to the characteristics of cycles, First, the cycle of awareness. Second, the cycle of growth. Third, the cycle of self-awareness. Fourth, the cycle of love or understanding. Fifth, the cycle of light or wisdom. Sixth, the cycle of light love, love light, or unity. Seventh, the gateway cycle. Eighth, the octave which moves into a mystery we do not plumb. Questioner, thank you very much. In previous material, before we communicated with you, it was stated by the Confederation that there is actually no past or future, all is present. Would this be a good analogy? I am raw. There is past, present, and future in third density. In an overview such as an entity may have, removed from the space-time continuum, it may be seen that in the cycle of completion there exists only the present. We, ourselves, seek to learn this understanding. At the seventh level or dimension, we shall, if our humble efforts are sufficient, become one with all, thus having no memory, no identity, no past or future, but existing in the all. Questioner, does this mean that you would have awareness of all that is? I am raw. This is partially correct. It is our understanding that it would not be our awareness, but simply awareness of the Creator. In the Creator is all that there is. Therefore, this knowledge would be available. Questioner, I was wondering how many inhabited planets there are in our galaxy and if they all reach higher density by the law of one, or if there is any other way. It doesn't seem to me that there would be any other way to reach higher density. Is this correct? I am raw. Please restate your query. Questioner, how many inhabited planets are there in our galaxy? I am raw. We are assuming that you intend all dimensions of consciousness or densities of awareness in this question. Approximately 1/5 of all planetary entities contain awareness of one or more densities. Some planetary spheres are hospitable only for certain densities. Your planetary sphere, for instance, is at this time hospitable to levels or densities 1, 2, 3, and 4. Questioner, well, roughly how many total planets in this galaxy of stars that we're in have aware life regardless of density? I am raw. Approximately 67 million. Questioner, can you tell me what percentage of those are third, fourth, fifth, sixth density, etc.? Roughly, very roughly. I am raw. A percentage 17 for first density, a percentage 20 for second density, a percentage 27 for third density, a percentage 16 for fourth density, a percentage 6 for fifth density. The other information must be withheld. The free will of your future is not making this available. We shall speak on one item. There is a fairly large percentage, approximately 35% of the intelligent planets, which do not fit in the percentiles. These mysteries are of sixth and seventh density and are not available for our speaking. Questioner, well, this first five densities, have all of them progressed from third density by knowledge and application of the law of one? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, then the only way for a planet to get out of the situation that we are in, or the only way for the population, is to become aware of and start practicing the law of one. Is this correct? This is correct. Questioner, can you tell me what percentage of third, fourth, and fifth density planets which you have spoken of here are negatively polarized? Polarized towards service for self? I am raw. This is not a query to which we may speak given the law of confusion. We may say only that the negatively or self-service oriented planetary spheres are much fewer. To give you exact numbers would not be appropriate. Questioner, I would like to make an analogy about why there are fewer negatively oriented and ask you if the analogy is good. In a positively oriented society with service to others, it would be simple to move a large boulder by getting everyone to help move it. In a society oriented towards service to self, it would be much more difficult to get everyone to work on the boulder for the good of all. Therefore, it is much easier to get things done to create the service to other principle and to grow in positively oriented communities than it is in negative. Is this correct? Inaudible. I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, thank you very much. Can you tell me how the Confederation of Planets was formed and why? I am raw. The desire to serve begins, in the dimension of love or understanding, to be an overwhelming goal of the social memory complex. Thus, those percentiles of planetary entities, plus approximately 4% more of whose identity we cannot speak, found themselves long, long ago in your time seeking the same thing. Service to others. The relationship between these entities as they entered an understanding of other beings, other planetary entities, and other concepts of service was to share and continue together these commonly held goals of service. Thus, Each voluntarily placed the social memory complex data in what you may consider a central thought complex available to all. This then created a structure whereby each entity could work in its own service while calling upon any other understandings needed to enhance the service. This is the cause of the formation and the manner of the working of the Confederation. Questioner, with such a large number of planets in this galaxy, I was wondering if you say there are approximately 500 Confederation planets. That seems to me to be a relatively small percentage of the total number of fourth and fifth density planets around. Is there any reason for this relatively small percentage in this Confederation? I am Raw. There are many Confederations. This Confederation works with the planetary spheres of seven of your galaxies, if you will, and is responsible for the callings of the densities of these galaxies. Questioner, would you define the word galaxy as you just used it? We use that term in this sense as you would use star systems. Questioner, I'm a little bit confused as to how many total planets then, roughly, does the Confederation that you are in serve? I am Raw. I see the confusion. We have difficulty with your language. The galaxy term must be split. We call galaxy that vibrational complex that is local. Thus, your sun is what we would call the center of a galaxy. We see you have another meaning for this term. Questioner, yes. In our science, the term galaxy refers to the lenticular star system that contains millions and millions of stars, and this had occurred earlier in our communications. This area of confusion, I'm glad to get it cleared up. Now, using the term galaxy in the sense that I just gave you, of the lenticular star system that contains millions of stars, do you know of the evolution in other galaxies besides this one? I am Raw. We are aware of life in infinite capacity. You are correct in this assumption. Questioner, can you tell me if the progression of life in the other galaxies is similar to progression in this one? I am Raw. The progression is somewhat close to the same, asymptotically approaching congruency throughout infinity. The free choosing of what you call galactic systems causes variations of an extremely minor nature from one of your galaxies to another. Questioner, and then the law of one is truly universal in creating the progression toward the eighth density or octave in all galaxies. Is this correct? I am Raw. This is correct. There are infinite forms, infinite understandings, but the progression is one. Questioner, I am assuming it is not necessary for an individual to understand the law of one to go from third to fourth density. Is this correct? I am Raw. It is absolutely necessary that an entity consciously realize it does not understand in order for it to be harvestable. Understanding is not of this density. Questioner, that is a very important point. I used the wrong word. What I meant to say was I believe that it was not necessary for an entity to be consciously aware of the law of one to go from third to fourth density. I am Raw. This is correct. Questioner, at what point in densities is it necessary for an entity to be consciously aware of the law of one to progress? I am Raw. The fifth density harvest is of those whose vibratory distortions consciously accept the honor duty of the law of one. This responsibility honor is the foundation of this vibration. Questioner, can you tell me a little more about this honor responsibility concept? I am Raw. Each responsibility is an honor. Each honor, a responsibility. Questioner, I want to ask a rather questionable question. I may not put it in the book. I was wondering if cattle mutilations that we now experience across the country and elsewhere could be explained by you. I am Raw. The greater part of your so-called mutilations take place according to the ways of your second density beings which feed upon carrion. A portion of these so-called mutilations are those which are of what you may call multidimensional type. A thought form construct using various parts in order to have life and being in third density. Questioner, where do these thought forms come from? I am Raw. This is a very ambiguous question. However, we will attempt to answer. Firstly, they come from the Creator. Secondly, they come from what you may call lower astral and plane thought. Thirdly, in construct visualization complex, they reside in part beneath the crust of your planet. Questioner, are these one form in particular? I am Raw. These entities may take any thought form associated with an emotion of fear or terror. Questioner, are these thought forms able to attack only cattle or can they also attack human beings? I am Raw. These thought forms cannot attack third density beings. Questioner, thank you. Can you tell me of the silver flecks that we have found sometimes on our faces or elsewhere? I am Raw. These of which you speak are a materialization of a subjectively oriented signpost indicating to one mind-body-spirit complex, and no other, a meaning of subjective nature. Questioner, who creates the silver flecks? Are they real? I am Raw. Picture, if you will, the increasing potential for learned teaching. At some point, a sign will be given to indicate the appropriateness or importance of that learned teaching. The entity itself, in cooperation with the inner planes, creates whatever signpost is most understandable or noticeable to it. Questioner, you're saying that we ourselves then create these? I am raw. Entities consciously do not create these. The roots of mind complex, having touched in understanding, intelligent infinity, create them. Questioner, thank you. Is it possible for you to give a small description of the conditions in fourth density? I am raw. We ask you to consider as we speak that there are no words for positively describing fourth density. We can only explain what is not and approximate to what is. Beyond fourth density, our ability grows more limited still until we become without words. That which fourth density is not, it is not of words, unless chosen. It is not of heavy chemical vehicles for body complex activities. It is not of disharmony within self. It is not of disharmony within peoples. It is not within limits of possibility to cause disharmony in any way. Approximations of positive statements, it is a plane of a type of bipedal vehicle which is much denser and more full of life. It is a plane wherein one is aware of the thoughts of other selves. It is a plane where one is aware of the vibrations of other selves. It is a plane of compassion and understanding of the sorrows of third density. It is a plane striving towards wisdom or light. It is a plane wherein individual differences are pronounced although automatically harmonized by group consensus. Questioner, could you define the word density as we have been using it to give us a little greater idea of the concept of this term when used by you? I am raw. The term density is a, what you would call, mathematical one. The closest analogy is that of music, whereby after seven notes on your Western type of scale, if you will, the eighth note begins a new octave. Within your great octave of existence which we share with you, there are seven octaves or densities. Within each density there are seven sub-densities. Within each sub-density, seven sub-sub-densities, and so on infinitely. Questioner, I notice that the time we have used has gone slightly over an hour. I would prefer to continue, but I want to ask at this time as to the condition of the instrument. I am raw. This instrument is in balance. It is well to continue if you desire. Questioner, all right. Continuing with what we were just talking about, namely densities, I understand then that each density has seven sub-densities which again have seven sub-densities which again have seven sub-densities. This expands at an extremely large rate as things are increased in powers of seven. Does this mean that in any density level anything that you can think of is happening? And many things that you never thought of are happening? Are there everything is happening? This is confusing. I am raw. From your confusion we select the concept with which you struggle. That being infinite opportunity, you may consider any possibility probability complex as having an existence. Questioner, does what we do, when we think of possibilities that can occur, say daydreaming, do these become real in these densities? I am raw. This depends upon the nature of the daydream. This is a large subject. Perhaps the simplest thing we can say is, if the daydream, as you call it, is one which attracts to self, this then becomes reality to self. If it is contemplative general daydream, this may enter the infinity of possibility probability complexes and occur elsewhere, having no particular attachment to the energy fields of the creator. Questioner, to make this a little more clear, if I were to daydream strongly about building a ship, would this occur in one of these other densities? I am raw. This would have, or shall occur. Questioner, and then if, say, an entity daydreams strongly about battling, let us say, another entity, would this occur? I am raw. In this case the entity's fantasy concerns the self and other self. This binds the thought form to the possibility probability complex connected with the self which is the creator of this thought form. This then would increase the possibility probability of bringing this into third density occurrence. Questioner, does the Orion group use this principle to create conditions brought about to suit their purpose? I am raw. We will answer more specifically than the question. The Orion group uses daydreams of hostile or other negative vibratory natures to feed back or strengthen these thought forms. Questioner, do they ever use any, shall I say, gratifications of the physical body to amplify such daydreams? I am raw. They are able to do this only when there is a strong ability on the part of the receiving mind-body-spirit complex towards the perception of thought forms. This could be termed an unusual characteristic but has indeed been a method used by Orion entities. Questioner, the many wanderers coming to this planet now and in the recent past, are they subject to Orion thoughts? I am raw. As we have said before, wanderers become completely the creature of third density in mind-body complex. There is just as much chance of such influence to a wanderer entity as to a mind-body-spirit complex of this planetary sphere. The only difference occurs in the spirit complex which, if it wishes, has an armor of light, if you will, which enables it to recognize more clearly that which is not as it would appropriately be desired by the mind-body-spirit complex. This is not more than a bias and cannot be called an understanding. Furthermore, the wanderer is, in its own mind-body-spirit complex, less distorted towards the, shall we say, deviousness of third density positive-negative confusions. Thus, it often does not recognize as easily as a more negative individual the negative nature of thoughts or beings. Questioner, would then the wanderers, as they incarnate here, be high priority targets, shall we say, of the Orion group? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, and if a wanderer were to be successfully infringed upon, shall I say, by the Orion group, what would happen to this wanderer at the harvest? I am raw. If the wanderer entity demonstrated through action a negative orientation towards other selves, it would be, as we have said before, caught into the planetary vibration and, when harvested, possibly repeat again the master cycle of third density as a planetary entity. This shall be the last full question of this session. Is there a short question we may answer before we close the session? Questioner, only just know if the instrument can be any more comfortable. I am raw. This instrument is as comfortable as it is possible for you to make it given the weakness distortions of its body complex. You are conscientious. I am raw. I leave you in the love and the light of the one infinite creator. Go forth, then, rejoicing in the power and the peace of the one creator. Adonai. End of session 16.